the World Wrestling Federation. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Now he wants a bunch of football players in his corner because he can't get the job done by himself. Well, I've got to call in to Tunney about that.
Obviously, you don't like it, do you?
No, I don't.
Well, you're going to like it even less, DiBiase, because coming up, in fact, right after this match, Todd Pettengill, on our WrestleMania report, is going to tell us who the members of LT's All-Pro team are.
Like I said, Monsoon, I got to call in to Tunney, so it's not going to make any difference. I'm not going to have a bunch of football players at ringside.
Danny Ackerman laying the bad mouth here on Billy Gunn. That won't help him too much. Ooh, wow, my shoulder box. Billy down quickly in front. Look out, roll, clothesline city.
I'm not going to take anything away from the Smoking Guns. They are a formidable team of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. But to go ahead and say,
ooh, wow, what a right hand.
They're going to give everybody an opportunity at the belts. That's pretty egotistical.
Well, a couple of weeks ago, they had a tremendous matchup against former champions, the Head Shrinkers. And, of course, you know who interfered in that one.
They had a tremendous match. I'm not saying they didn't, but did they win? No, they didn't win that match.
They didn't lose, did they?
No, but they didn't win.
Still the champions, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
Well, I think they're home. Nice single leg drop there by Bart. There are some tremendous teams, of course, that were not involved in the tournament that I would like to see them in against. Guys like Eli and Jacob.
Eli and Jacob Blue. There's a team that I think everybody better be keeping an eye on, especially these champions here.
Well, DiBiase, you're always crybabying about something. In fact, we've got another guy standing by right now who's not too happy, talking about the Rocket King himself, Owen Hart.
This is really getting ridiculous now. Smoking Guns, you're giving everybody a title shot except me. What about me? Let me get a partner, and I can beat you guys. Come on, this isn't fair.
Oh, look at that double neck breaker. Wow. These guys can put it all together.
Unbelievable.
You know, Owen doesn't have a partner.
Well, he had Bob Backlund as a partner.
Yeah, but he found out that Bob was more paranoid than he was.
Well, he might have a point there, Monty.
Smoking Guns really unloading now. And poor Bobby Wade on the receiving end. Look out here. Oh, look at this. Ring around the rosy. Big leg drop, yes.
Oh, see ya. Think this one's all over, Monsoon.
Get the hot water turned on. Chalked up another one in the wind column for Billy and Bart Gunn. Reigning World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Don't forget, folks, still to come. Tatanka, Mad Mountain Rock, Wayne, Jacob, and Eli Blue. We've got Todd Pettengill standing by with our WrestleMania report, but before that, let's go
forse di nome.
My name is Todd Pettengill. This is your very first WrestleMania report, and I got to tell you, when you talk about WrestleMania, you're talking about the most action-packed and glamorous night of the entire year. Bigger than the Academy Awards. Hotter than the Super Bowl. More exciting than the Final Four. Check this out. The WWF is beginning its second decade of bringing you family sports entertainment and the hottest stars on the planet. WrestleMania from the WWF is the event that put pay-per-view television on the map. So when you call your local cable company to place your order, make sure you ask for WrestleMania by name. This year, WrestleMania 11, coming to you totally live from the sold-out Hartford Civic Center in Connecticut, Sunday night, April the 2nd, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, and exclusively on pay-per-view cable TV. Right now, folks, let's talk about some of the star power that's lining up for WrestleMania 11. We're talking about Pamela Anderson from the hit syndicated TV show Baywatch. Certainly, as most of you know by now, Pamela Anderson will be walking Shawn Michaels to the squared circle for his title shot, an honor he earned by winning the 1995 WWF Royal Rumble match this past January in Tampa. You will also see NYPD Blues Nicholas Turturro, who will be a guest ring announcer. Only fitting a star from TV's hottest show be part of wrestling's biggest night. Plus, Home Improvement's Jonathan Taylor Thomas will be a guest broadcaster. Now, here's a guy at a very young age who's done a lot. He's done the voice of Simba in The Lion King, the biggest box office hit of all time. He's got a new flick coming out with Chevy Chase. He will also be part of WrestleMania 11 this April in Hartford. In addition, you will see the beautiful Jennifer McCarthy from MTV, who will act as a guest timekeeper. The list of superstars continues to grow, and I will keep you posted and updated in the weeks to come as we count down to WrestleMania 11. But right now, let's switch gears a little bit and talk about just a few of the matches you will see at WrestleMania this year. Of course, the WWF title will be on the line as Big Daddy Cool Diesel defends the gold against the winner of the Royal Rumble match, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, with his bodyguard, Sid. Now, this one has been building ever since Diesel and Shawn parted company, and the fireworks should be absolutely awesome. Plus, as everybody has heard by now, future NFL Hall of Famer Lawrence Taylor will actually step into the squared circle to face Bam Bam Bigelow one-on-one. As a matter of fact, LT got so irate after seeing Bam Bam Bigelow on Monday Night Raw insulting his manhood and integrity, he showed up at last Tuesday's press conference at the Harley-Davidson Cafe in Manhattan to accept the challenge of the Beast from the East. Now, Lawrence Taylor has admitted, hey, I'm not a professional wrestler. However, he has never backed down from a challenge before and won't this time either. But LT's not stupid. He knows what can happen when you step off against a guy like Bam Bam Bigelow, right? So he wants to make sure there is no outside interference in this match. And to guarantee that, LT will bring his all-pro team to Hartford to watch his back at ringside. And man, it reads like a who's who. Let me introduce you to Lawrence Taylor's all-pro team. Reggie White of the Green Bay Packers, Ricky Jackson and Ken Norton Jr. of the Super Bowl champion San Francisco 49ers, Steve McMichael, former Chicago Bear, now Green Bay Packer, Carl Banks, a former teammate of LT's on the Giants, now a Cleveland Brown, and Chris Spielman of the Detroit Lions. Can you imagine what it's going to be like at ringside? Because, of course, the million-dollar team will all be there in force with Ted DiBiase to watch Bam Bam Bigelow's back, talking about King Kong Bundy, Tonka, IRS, and Nikolai Volkov. WrestleMania 11 is not only the start of our second decade in the World Wrestling Federation, it is the epitome of the new WWF generation. The biggest matches, the biggest celebrities, and the biggest night of the year. Sunday, April the 2nd, totally live from the sold-out Hartford Civic Center, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, exclusively on pay-per-view. Now, still to come here this week, a visit to the Heartbreak Hotel with Shawn Michaels and his new bodyguard, Sid.
Well, folks, welcome back. We're about to take a look at the martial arts expert, Quang. And you know something, DiBiase? Arithmetic was never one of my strong points. But according to what Todd said, the all-pro team has you guys outnumbered seriously.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what. If you're putting together a football team, it's pretty impressive. Reggie White, Steve McMichael, Ken Norton Jr., Ricky Jackson, Chris Spielman, Carl Banks. But we're not talking football. We're talking the World Wrestling Federation. And they're not coming down to ringside if I can help it. And they're certainly not coming down with football pads and helmets on.
Hey, so, we're talking about big, tough guys. That's what we're talking about.
Yeah, well, you think my corporation's not a bunch of big, tough guys?
Huh? Well, they certainly are, but I think they're a little outnumbered here, as I said earlier on. Take a look at this mystery man. Martial arts expert from the Orient. I'd like to see a matchup between this guy and Hakushi.
That would be something to see, Gorilla Monsoon. Yes, indeed it would.
Well, talking about Hakushi, he's going to have one of the feature matchups this week on the Action Zone as he faces Bob Sparkplug Holly.
There's going to be a lot of big news on the Action Zone this week.
There is.
Consider, yeah, the corporation's going to make a little announcement.
They are. What is it?
I'll tell you about it later.
Oh. You're not going to... Well, maybe the rumor's true that you sent the urn to MIT for an MRI.
What?
That's what I heard. Oh, wow. Roundhouse right in the corner and 360 and out of there. Oh, no.
Oh, here
not
goes.
This way.
Not again.
That's it over that way.
Ooh.
Oh, it's the orange stuff this week.
Boy.
Wow. Exclusive World Wrestling Federation double feature coming up right now. Here's action that went down only moments ago.
Ooh.
As well as action that's going on right now. Oh, this youngster getting hammered here.
Oh, there you go. He went in again. How does he do that? How does he do that?
That is sickening. It's almost as bad as Henry Godwin's slop bucket.
Nah, don't get too heavy on Henry now. I like him.
Gary Scott getting pulverized here. Getting hammered from every which direction. Oh, look at this.
Oh, what a shot.
What an underhook. Reverse. Thrust Savant kick.
You know, Quang was one of the five finalists in the ring in the last week's Battle Royal.
But he didn't win.
No, he didn't win.
Of course, I had the privilege of calling that. Oh, look at this.
Ooh.
360 and whoa. Scott made it. Oh, no, he got caught with another one.
Unbelievable.
It's lights out time.
I believe you're right.
Ooh. Wow. Very impressive indeed.
He is your winner.
Quang. Just about the only meal ticket that little runt Harvey Whippleman's got left now, isn't it?
Well, he still has well done.
Well, he certainly does. Coming up right now, it's live event news. Don't you dare touch that remote.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyant. The WWF in high gear is coming to Madison Square Garden Sunday, March 19th. At a start time of 2 p.m., this event is just 2 weeks from today. In one of the most controversial tag team pairings ever, the bad guys from Miami, Razor Ramon, and Big Daddy Cool Diesel team up to face off against their enemies, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Double J Jeff Jarrett. What a match this one will be. Now, The Undertaker will take on the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow. Gentlemen, go right ahead.
Oh, yes, it's very true. Much of my Undertaker's power is derived from the sacred earth. But a lot of the power comes from you, the creatures of the night.
Bam Bam Bigelow. If your hopes of defeating the Undertaker lie in the possession of that urn, you are in for a grave evening. That power comes only to me. And the power contained in that urn will consume you and destroy you.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. If you tuned in to Superstars yesterday, you know about this challenge that was just issued. Bret Hart and Davey Boy Smith are taking on Owen Hart and Jerry the King Lawler in a tag team match. Now, Lawler has leveled some pretty substantial accusations against the Hitman. What will happen when these four meet in the ring? Tickets are available at the box office and all Ticketmaster ticket centers. And tickets for the WWF Fan Festival, sponsored by Tyco, are now available. Just call the numbers on your screen for more information. Don't forget, WWF in High Gear will be live at Madison Square Garden Sunday, March 19th.
Are you ready?
I'm ready!
Then rule!
Let's start jamming!
Then come on, Monsoon.
For man!
I know how to hear this.
Milton!
I like that a lot better, and I like that wrapped up.
At least this guy's got some real talent, unlike Double J.
What?
Well, have you heard him sing? I haven't.
I've been telling you that for months now, Monsoon, yeah.
Can't find a CD anywhere?
That's
this
what?
Guy's got a CD.
Can't find Double J because it's always sold out.
Wait, I want to hear this. Get down!
Sit down, Monsoon.
Oh, sorry. You must have had a good time here without me last week, right?
A wonderful time.
Yeah. Go get him, man.
Hey, what are you doing telling Stan Lane to ask me for hot dogs?
Well, did you get any?
No. He didn't give me any money either.
This guy is loaded with talent.
Nice hair, too.
We're going to find out what kind of wrestling talent he's got in just a moment.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
There are two kinds of snacks. One for wimps and punks. And the others for me. You need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim.
It's here. Series 2 of Magic Works. Hidden Sun, Eye of the Pharaoh, Missing Masterpiece, Secret Slate, and more. Series 2 of Magic Works.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in store soon.
Man Mountain Rock, Dale Peterson, gingerly.
Oh, and the brawl is not wasting any time.
He didn't even wait for the bell.
Well, I'll tell you what. He's taking the advantage right now, and he better keep it, because Man Mountain Rock, Daryl Peterson, his real name, was an All-American wrestler at Iowa State.
Boy, he certainly was. Oh, look at that! Ramming the left shoulder, and what is that?
I don't know. He's winding up for something.
Boy, he's I think he was strumming it there.
Oh!
Here he comes off the ropes. Airborne, yes! What a powerful elbow that was.
You know, Monsoon, I understand that in addition to playing that guitar, he writes his own music.
And sings, too.
Yeah, but no CDs from him, huh?
Oh, he's got a CD, and I saw, look at that. Suplex Brawler in a whole lot of trouble here this week.
No.
Oh, yeah. He dances, too.
Well, Jimmy Del Rey there.
Well, he can do it all, I guess.
Yeah, well, he has no sellout CDs, not like Double J.
A lot of guys here in the World Wrestling Federation not too excited about stepping into the ring and facing Man Mountain Rock, Irish Whip here.
Ooh, wow.
Whoa, look out. Oh, if he'd have landed that one, it would have been over.
Uh-oh.
Brawler now going to the outside. Take a look. It took him forever to get up there. He paid for it.
Yes, he did.
You know, maybe we're going to see Man Mountain Rock test out that new whammy bar to you. Oh, there it is. That's the whammy bar right there. This is a submission hold. Oh, listen to him squeal.
Well,
the Brawler's going to quit here.
Well, the Brawler's giving it up, and as he's giving it up, I've never heard of the whammy bar, by the way. I'm getting out of here, Monsoon, because a real man's up next. My man, gaga.
Well, don't forget the hot dogs on the way back. And when we return, we'll have the Tonga in action, and we'll also see the million-dollar man caught in another scam.
Folks, let me take this opportunity to remind you that two great new releases from Coliseum Home Video will be available this Wednesday. One is, of course, the 1995 Royal Rumble featuring the greatest Royal Rumble match of all time. And two, Wham Bam Body Slam. Wait till you see the perfect prank perpetrated by Doink and Dink. And get this, folks, every match on this home video is a Coliseum exclusive. So get your copies this Wednesday at video stores everywhere.
Tax evasion, extortion, and that's just the beginning, Mr. DiBiase.
Allegations.
Allegations. Look, you don't have anything concrete on me or the corporation, Totoro.
Oh, yeah? Well, yesterday we received a complaint from a distraught little boy. He said you've been scalping WrestleMania tickets for $1,000 a pop.
Look, the way I see it, I was doing a little punk a favor. I was making him a deal. WrestleMania is the most awesome spectacular in sports entertainment. And we're talking about ringside seats.
Ringside seats?
The last four left.
Last four, huh? What do you say to credit cards?
I can't believe it. I'm really going to WrestleMania.
Boy, what an ingrate, that million-dollar man. You know, you could do time for that, DiBiase. That's a felony. Here he comes. Well, probably right now the biggest hope for DiBiase to bring some gold into that corporation lies in this turncoat, this Native American, Tatanka. And he's become a very unscrupulous individual as well. And he really showed his true colors last Monday night on Monday Night Raw when he ran away from a beating that was being administered to him by Made in the USA Lex Luger. Man like a thief in the night. Ricky Santana supplying the opposition. Well, I don't see the urn. DiBiase did not bring the urn down to the ring. In fact, he didn't have it with him here either. Well, I understand they're in trouble, that urn. A little bit of a problem with it. They can't figure it out. And I also heard through the gorilla vine that Nikolai was caught making beef stroganoff in the urn. And now he's not on too good terms with Ted DiBiase. Ooh, Ricky right into the face first into the top turnbuckle. Tatanka, real powerhouse, up around that 270-pound mark. But speed and agility dropkick drops the Native American. Real ring veteran competition here in the form of Ricky Santana. Can you believe what he did to his former mentor, Chief J. Strongbow, Hall of Famer here in the World Wrestling Federation? Someone that was looked up to by Tatanka before he got the whiff of the green stuff. What a disgusting person. Put him in the same category with a Rocket King, Owen Hart. Oh, look at that. Put his head down. Sunset Flip, is he going to get him now? Wow. What a big upset that would have been. Tatanka does not like to be made to look bad. And Ricky doing a good job of it right now. Backslide coming up. Yes. Drive with the legs. Ricky, no, he didn't do it. Well, for that hole to be successful, you got to do that. High cross body. Sends him down again. Well, Tatanka obviously thinking about a lot of other things besides Ricky Santana. Trading right hands and getting the worst of that. Irish whip coming up now. Look out, one step too many. Tatanka suckered him into that, just like the Million Dollar Man and Bam Bam suckered LT into agreeing to that matchup at WrestleMania 11. But, you know, the whole thing could turn around and blow up right in the Million Dollar Man's kisser. I wouldn't want to go out there and see the likes of Reggie White and Ken Norton staring me down. That would give you a negative attitude. Another Irish whip coming up here. Santana hard in the corner. Clothesline City and nailed him. Look at the condition that Tatanka's in. Hasn't broken a sweat yet in this one, and probably won't before it's all over. Referee admonishes. Oh, here it comes. Talk about it being over. It's the end of the trail indeed for Ricky Santana. Very impressive showing here this week by Native American Tatanka, putting out the lights for young Ricky Santana. Right now, folks, we're going to show you some exclusive footage from last week's World Wrestling Federation Superstars Big Battle Royal that I had the pleasure of calling with Vincent K. McMahon. And wait till you see what Bret the Hitman Hart did. Well, he made a monkey out of Jerry Lawler.
He's out of
Hey!
from the book of the man who won the Royal Rumble, Shawn Michaels.
Hopping around on one foot. Still in there.
He's going to win it, Carmella. He's going to win this thing. No, there's no way that anyone in the ring would think that he has to be eliminated.
Opportunity to once again thank all the hundreds of fans, our great fans in the Big Apple, New York City, for braving the elements last Tuesday to attend the World Wrestling Federation press conference for WrestleMania 11 at the Harley Davidson Cafe. Hats off to you guys.
Sure, they all turned out to see me and Bam Bam Bigelow, and we really do appreciate it.
What? Yeah. See, you and Nick came out to CLT.
They were wrestling fans, not football fans.
Give me a break, DiBiase. DiBiase, if you remember, when these two guys interjected themselves in a match that the Smoking Guns were in with the Head Shrinkers, and it was obvious to me, DiBiase, that Eli and Jacob would much prefer to face the Smoking Guns than the Head Shrinkers.
Well, look at how unpredictable and unorthodox the Head Shrinkers are. I mean, they're crazy. You never know what they're going to do. I would say that's a pretty good choice.
Well, Jumbo Beretta here getting hammered right from the get-go.
Ooh, wow.
Hey, ref, this is a tag match. One guy at a time, please.
You know, since coming to the World Wrestling Federation, I don't believe that I've heard either one of these gentlemen, Eli or Jacob, utter a word.
No, but Zebekiah, he doesn't, just ask him his name and he'll give you a 30-minute dissertation on something.
He'll tell you exactly what he thinks, and I like that, the guy.
One man out.
Once again, both team members in the ring at the same time. Referee allowing a lot of latitude in this one, and I don't like it.
Referee didn't know which guy to put out, Gorilla Monsoon.
What's the difference? You put out one. There's two of them. He can count at least, can he?
Yeah. Being identical twins could be a big advantage in a tough tag situation.
Well, maybe we'll hear him speak because we have a pre-recorded statement from the three beauties standing by right now.
You know, me and the boys have been talking about it, me and my two nephews, Jacob and Eli, we've been talking about it. We decided on one thing. We're going to challenge everybody. We're issuing an open challenge right now to any tag team in the World Wrestling Federation that wants to step in the ring with us. If you got the guts, we'll be there.
Well, I'm not surprised that they wouldn't be there.
Well, we heard from Uncle Zabakiah again. Not a word from either Eli or Jacob. I kind of like that, though. He just kind of grabs him right by the scuff of the neck, controls him. I like that. I like control. Of course, you know I like that.
Yeah, I do. But you've lost control. Oh, nice reversal there and short clothesline by Eli or Jacob. I think you lost control on the WrestleMania 11 confrontation, though, with Bam Bam and LT.
Oh, you gotta be kidding, Grelmer. See?
Look, you dragged him across just like a
caveman style.
You know, I'll tell you what, DiBiase, if these guys want to be, watch this, ram that lower lumbar area right in the top turnbuckle. If they want to be deemed, then again, number one challengers, they're going to have to meet some stiffer competition.
Well, there's plenty of tag team competition in the WWF, but I don't care if it's Men on a Mission, the Headshrinkers, the Heavenly Bodies. Look at these two guys. I think they're going to end up number one, bar none. I mean, and you know what I like the most about them? Look at them. You can control them. Unlike a lot of these high-priced athletes in the world of professional sports these days.
Are you saying that you're having trouble controlling your corporate members?
No, I didn't say that.
This could be the big news you were talking about.
No. I'm not having any problem.
Oh. Certainly appeared that way, sounded that way to me.
Always trying to stir it up, aren't you, Mike?
Well,
yeah.
It's part of my job as a broadcast journalist.
Yeah.
But once again, look at them. Both of them in the ring. Referee not even attempting to make a count as they double press slam this poor soul. Oh, the elevator just went to the basement.
Well, would you like to tell them what to do?
Yeah, I would. If I were a referee, if that was my job.
But it's not.
You're right. How are you going to feel, DiBiase, when you look across the ring and you see Reggie White and Ken Norton Jr. and Ricky Jackson and Carl Banks staring you down? You're not going to like it, are you?
Well, Monsoon, I wouldn't like to look across the ring and see that, but that's not a done deal yet anyway, so.
It's not.
No, it's not.
It's a done deal as far as I'm concerned.
No, I told you.
Did you hear what Todd said?
You haven't heard from Tunney yet either.
Oh.
Nor have you heard the last from me on this issue.
Another quick tag. I don't know why they bother to tag. They just come in and out whenever they feel like it. Ooh. Look, he planted him. The leg drop coming. Forget about it. Mercifully, this one is over.
A lot of teams here in the World Wrestling Federation better be paying close attention to Eli and Jacob Blue.
Oh, you set a mouthful that time, DiBiase. These guys are destined for stardom here in the World Wrestling Federation. But coming up right now, folks, courtesy of the World Wrestling Federation, in high gear, a special Heartbreak Hotel with Shawn Michaels and his bodyguard, Psycho Sid.
Think I'm cute. I know I'm sexy.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Heartbreak Hotel.
Before I bring out my very, very special guest, the Heartbreak Kid is going to give you his top 10 reasons why I will become the new World Wrestling Federation champion at WrestleMania. The Heartbreak Kid is a hot-blooded, heart-pounding hunk. Number 9. Judge Ito has overruled all of Jack Tunney's objections. The number 8 reason why the Heartbreak Kid will become the next World Wrestling Federation champion: he has the natural, God-given ability to take the World Wrestling Federation to new heights. The number 7 reason. I already told Pam Anderson I would. Number 6. I have proven time and time again that the super kick is the Achilles heel of Big Daddy Cool Diesel. The number 5 reason why Shawn Michaels will be the new World Wrestling Federation champion: I made Big Daddy Cool Diesel, and I can and will break Big Daddy Cool Diesel. The number four reason. I told you I would go through 29 superstars in the 1995 Royal Rumble, and I did. And the number three reason, HB will be the new WWF champ, is because I can and will become a Triple Crown winner. And the number two reason, it's because I said so. And the number one reason why the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, will become the next World Wrestling Federation champion at WrestleMania 11 is because you could call it justice. You could call him vicious. You can call him psycho, but I call him sick. Has a couple words for you.
See, you want to know why I am the number one reason? I will tell you, it is simple. When I walk, the ground under my feet shake. When I talk, every man in the World Wrestling Federation, they listen. And everyone fears the man that you are looking at. And together, the Heartbreak Kid and Psycho Sid will rule the world.
My oh my, I believe it is checkout time.
Stop us! No one has got the guts!
Welcome back, everyone. This week's WWF Wrestling Challenge is brought to you by new, bigger Stridex medicated pads. It's simple, triple control. What an unbelievable combo we have in Shawn Michaels and Psycho Sid.
I've said it once. I've said it a million times. Shawn Michaels is a very cunning individual, and he has covered all the bases, Gorilla Monsoon. He has practically ensured the fact that he will indeed become the next World Wrestling Federation champion. I gotta take my hat off.
Oh, look at this! Pinwheels for the Portuguese man of war, Aldo Montoya. Hey, Shawn Michaels isn't right all the time, you know. Look at, he went out and had a couple of dates with Pam Anderson, and she went back and married her old boyfriend.
Yeah, well, she was all goo-goo-eyed over Shawn Michaels, and she found out that Shawn was the marrying kind, so she ran back to this guy. But I guarantee you, by WrestleMania, forget about it. He'll have her. He'll be leading around by the nose, and she'll forget.
Ooh,
that
nice
guy.
Shoulder block.
They don't call him the Heartbreak Kid for nothing, Gorilla.
Oh, maybe they won't call him the Heartbreak. Oh, dropkick. Nicely executed by Aldo Montoya.
So after WrestleMania 11, they're going to call him World Wrestling Federation Champion Heartbreak
Well,
Kid.
What goodness if that happens, DiBiase? Oh, wait a minute, look at this! Montoya over the top, right down onto Charlie, and the Charlie Hunter in deep trouble here.
You were saying, Girl Monsoon, you were asking me a question.
I did, but I'm sure someone's got a straight answer, do I? Oh, look at this, off the top, yes! Here nailed it with a right hand right in the kisser.
I believe what you were trying to ask me, Monsoon, was if Shawn Michaels becomes World Wrestling Federation champion, what good does it do me? Right?
Doesn't put any gold in your corporation, does it?
Did it ever dawn on you that I could buy Shawn Michaels too? That I could add him to the corporation?
Yeah, well, you'd have to buy Psycho Sid too.
Well, that's big. I've got unlimited resources, Monsoon. I told you a long time ago.
Oh, look out!
You and everybody else before it's all over. I'll own the World Wrestling Federation.
You're talking about bringing me back a couple of lousy hot dogs with your unlimited money. Charlie Hunter exhibiting a little offense of his own here. Oh, a two count on Montoya, but comes right out the back door nicely.
I'm trying to do you a favor. You don't need those hot dogs. They're full of fat. You've got enough.
Boy, oh boy, you're something. I suppose you humiliated poor Stan Lane last week during my absence, didn't you?
Every opportunity I got.
Yeah. Well, you won't humiliate Reggie White or Steve McMichaels or Ken Norton or Ricky Jackson or Chris Spielman or Carl Banks.
You're like a broken record, Monsoon.
Well, look at the numbers there. Holy mackerel.
Well, they're not wearing shoulder pads when they come down to ringside, and I got the entire corporation standing in front of me, so they got a lot to get through before they get
through. What whole entire corporation? Who are you talking about? Running Scared, Tatanka,
Bundy,
Irwin, the Repossessor, and Nikolai, your first acquisition?
Yep.
What a big thrill that was for you, huh?
They'll all be there, and...
Wow, what a move that was.
Well, like I said before, there's going to be a big announcement this Sunday on the Action Zone. I'll tell you later.
What kind of announcement?
Always surprises from the Million Dollar Man, Monsoon. That's all you got to know.
Did you buy somebody else?
Just watch.
I always watch. That's how I know what's going on. Bulldog off the second turnbuckle on the inside. That should just about do it. Although Montoya enjoying tremendous success here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Could have enjoyed a lot more if he'd have taken my offer and taken the money. He could have been with me now.
Well, he was undefeated, of course, until he ran into the Mantar a few weeks ago. But right now, let's catch up on the news. It's coming your way right after this.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Only Spidey's arachnid abilities and the Fantastic Four can stop 20 supervillains in the all-new Spider-Man video game. Also look for X-Men on home video.
True Lies explodes onto your favorite video game system. It's up to you to battle fanatical terrorists and save the world from nuclear destruction from a plane.
Welcome back to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand. The WWF in High Gear is going to be live at Madison Square Garden Sunday, March 19th at a start time of 2 p.m. This event is only 2 weeks away. Big Daddy Cool Diesel and the bad guy Razor Ramon want to set the record straight in the worst way. You're going to get a chance to take on the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Double J Jeff Jarrett, their arch rivals. Double J will no doubt have the infamous roadie tagging along as well. Now, The Undertaker will take on Bam Bam Bigelow. Bam Bam, of course, part of the corporation that possesses the urn. Now, we heard from The Undertaker earlier in the hour. Bam Bam Bigelow standing by insisting that I give him equal airtime. So, take it away, Mr. Bigelow.
Look, Undertaker, and all you people out there, Madison Square Garden, New York City, that is Bam Bam Bigelow's backyard, and I will not go into the garden and be embarrassed. Let me tell you something, Undertaker. The way I see it, I have the advantage. I have the urn, and the urn harnesses your power. The last time in the garden, I left you laying. That's right, you were powerless. And this time, I'm gonna bury you for good, Undertaker, because in New York City, in Madison Square Garden, you're all mine.
Well, one thing Bam Bam Bigelow is, direct. If you were watching Superstars yesterday, you'll know about this tag team matchup. Bret the Hitman Hart and his brother-in-law, British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith, are going to take on Owen Hart and Jerry the King Lawler. Now, Lawler has been leveling several accusations about the Hitman recently. Maybe they'll finally get cleared up in New York. We'll just have to see. Now, tickets are available at the box office and all Ticketmaster ticket centers, and the WWF Fan Festival is just weeks away. Tickets for the Fan Festival are available at the Hartford Civic Center box office and all Ticketmaster ticket centers. But don't forget, WWF in High Gear live at the Madison Square Garden, Sunday, March 19th, 2 weeks away.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lawrence Taylor.
I'm a man, and I do believe in having a good time. I do believe in showing respect to people. And I think what he did that wrestling match in Tampa was uncalled for. It's the only reason why I'm going into the ring.
You wanted to shake my hand in the Royal Rumble?
As you saw in our opening, the handshake between Bam Bam Bigelow and Lawrence Taylor. Well, as far as I'm concerned, folks, a handshake from Bam Bam is about as sincere as a si senor from Rosa Lopez, you might say. Take a look. Wow. This match, of course, gaining tremendous publicity over the past several weeks all over the world. Can't wait for WrestleMania 11 to see these two guys inside the squared circle. The chant is going out, LT. You can bet that in the Hartford Civic Center, 3 weeks from now, that will be a deafening chant. Bam Bam just going to work immediately. Take a look, King Kong Bundy out there as well. And the big surprise, yes, DiBiase unfolded it. He has added to his corporation yet another member. You're looking at him right now, the Supreme Fighting Machine, comma. Well, last week he wouldn't make a statement telling us who was going to be, but that he'd have a surprise. Well, Lawrence Taylor got a few surprises too. Well, Mr. Moneybags, nice snap mare out of the corner. Everyone, oh, beautiful reverse thrust kick there by Bam Bam. Everyone, of course, thinking and questioning LT's strategy about stepping inside the, oh, nice clothesline, squared circle with Bam Bam, because, holy mackerel, how's Lawrence Taylor going to deal with a move like that? How's Lawrence Taylor going to be able to come up close to the experience of Bam Bam Bigelow inside the squared circle, even though he is under the tutelage of WWF Champion Diesel? Come on, ref, make him break it. Bam Bam just hammering away here, obviously trying to send a message to Lawrence Taylor. There is no substitute, folks, for experience. Ooh, headbutt right between the eyes. Biggest strong point right now going for LT, of course, is that tremendous entourage that will be backing him up. All the potential NFL Hall of Famers. Oh, look at that. Over the top rope and out of there. Well, he doesn't want to hear that chant, LT. I wish I could hear what he's saying. I can read lips pretty good, though. Nikolai Volkoff along with Tatanka, King Kong Bundy, and the latest acquisition, comma, the Supreme Fighting Machine, will all be there in the corner of Bam Bam at WrestleMania 11 just 3 weeks from now. Ooh, what a slam. Bam Bam now just having a good time at the expense of this youngster. Look out, where's he going? Going to be airborne Bam Bam here in just a moment. You make that kind of a mistake with Lawrence Taylor, hey, a shoulder block will put you out for head. Bill Payne showing a little offense of his own right now. Clothesline, but doesn't knock the big guy down. Just staggered him. And another one. Bam Bam reeling a little bit here. Drop kick. He went down to one knee. Well, I guess that may be the only concession Bill Payne is going to get here. This move could be a little premature here, as Bam Bam wasn't in. Oh, look at that power slam off the top turnbuckle. That is the beginning of the end, believe me, folks. Can't make those kind of mistakes. Oh, the way he's climbing, and we may see a moonsault here by Bam Bam. Yes! Hope you're watching, LT. That's what you've got to look forward to 3 weeks from now at the Hartford Civic Center as we kick off the second decade of WrestleMania, WrestleMania 11. Easy victory here for Bam Bam Bigelow. I can guarantee you this, folks, it won't be that easy against LT. We're going to go back and take a look at some of the action that went down earlier in this one. Bam Bam catching the youngster off the top turnbuckle. Wow, look at that moonsault. When we come back, folks, I'm sure that Ted DiBiase will be rejoining me, and we'll be taking a look at the dynamic 1-2-3 kick.
If I have to fold one more box, I'm going to snap.
Ooh. Did you say snap?
Snap into a Slim Jim! Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim!
How nice of you, DiBiase, to come down out of your ivory tower. You know, you sat right here and made the statement that you baited Lawrence Taylor. You set the trap. Yeah. You baited the hook. You caught him. But obviously, you didn't count on the six tremendous potential NFL Hall of Famers that are going to be looking out for LT's interest.
The key word there, Monsoon, is potential. Lawrence Taylor potentially could be a great wrestler, but he doesn't have enough time to get ready for a seasoned veteran like Bam Bam Bigelow.
Well, right now, DiBiase, he's under the tutelage of WWF Champion Diesel.
Well, like I said before, there's not enough time between now and WrestleMania 11 for it to make a difference. LT, WrestleMania 11 is going to be a long night.
Well, we heard enough from you and Bam Bam. Let's hear from Lawrence Taylor.
I don't run from him. I think that would mix a man a man. You know, if you can mix it up with the best of them and take what comes, you'll be fine. I've been going against the odds all my life. I go against one, two, three, four people all the time. I find a way to get by them. I find a way to get the job done. April 2nd, I'm going to go out there like a bunch of crazed dogs and have some fun.
Tell you what, Gorilla Monsoon, he had better not think about coming out and attacking Bam Bam Bigelow with reckless abandon. You don't attack a seasoned veteran, somebody who knows his way around the square circle like Bam Bam Bigelow, when you don't have any experience in the square circle. Lawrence Taylor, you better step back and think a little bit about what you're doing. I still say you're in for a very long night.
Tremendous ovation here for the sensational 1-2-3 kid. You know, now that I think about it, DiBiase, why not treat it as Lawrence Taylor's treating it? He's got everything to gain and nothing to lose. Your guy beats up on Lawrence Taylor, people are going to say, well, here's a seasoned professional taking advantage of a guy who's never been inside a square circle before. But if Lawrence Taylor does a number on Bam Bam, what a slap in the face, not only to Bam Bam, but to the complete corporation.
Well, I'll tell you what. It's not going to happen, Gorilla Monsoon. We have a tremendous amount of confidence. And what do you mean we have nothing to gain?
Oh, look at this up over the top.
For Bam Bam Bigelow and the corporate.
I said you've got everything to lose.
We have a lot to gain. It's like this, Gorilla Monsoon. When we beat Lawrence Taylor, the greatest NFL superstar of all time at WrestleMania 11, I mean, it's going to get worldwide recognition. We're going to get endorsements. We're going to get a lot of money. What do you mean? I mean, we're in.
Ooh, wow, what a shoulder block.
It couldn't be better for the corporation.
Well, the big word you said there, DiBiase. Oh, look at the block there. Watch this move. Yes, 360. Oh, beautiful roundhouse.
What a shot.
The key word there, DiBiase, if you beat Lawrence Taylor.
No, I didn't say if.
Yes, you did.
No, win.
Oh, win. You said if.
No.
Ooh, wow. Bandom now exerting himself. You know, DiBiase, I'm going to take you back in time to WrestleMania 2. Obviously, you weren't there, but it was a over-the-top battle royal, and one of the guys who did the best was an NFL star by the name of William the Refrigerator Perry.
Who?
Oh, please. You're not familiar with William Perry, the fridge? Give me a break. Where you been, under a big rock somewhere? Oh, slam here by the Phantom. 1, 2, 3, kid in trouble.
What the fridge had in his favor was he had a whole lot of weight to push around, which Lawrence Taylor does not. And Bam Bam Bigelow is a great big man with just as much agility, just as much quickness and speed. Lawrence Taylor's in trouble.
You know, I'll give you this. Bam Bam is quick. Kid's in trouble right now as well. Bam Bam is quick inside the ring, but I don't think he can match the speed of Lawrence Taylor. And hey, when it comes to gray matter, no way, shape, or form can Bam Bam match anyone.
Give me a break. Well, it's as simple as this, Gorilla Monsoon. The best thing Lawrence Taylor can do at this point,
who slam here by the Phantom,
is climb in the ring and run and hope that time runs out.
Please.
Because
Phantom,
as soon as
the outside,
as soon as Bam Bam gets his paws on him, it's over.
Perched all the way up there on the top. Look, it's taking him forever to get up there. Oh. Too long. A drop kick sends the Phantom flying. 1, 2, 3, kid was in a whole lot of trouble. 1, 2, 3, kid has had a little experience with Mr. Easter Egg. Oh, beautiful roundhouse.
I'd get out of there too if I was him.
Well, yeah. That's what Bam Bam's going to be doing. Yeah. Oh, it's not even safe out there. And it won't be safe, I guarantee you, outside the ring at WrestleMania 11.
It'll be safe, all right, because the entire corporation is going to be there to protect Bam Bam.
Kid on the outside now going all the way up top. Boy, he loves it up there with the air. His rare, and this one is history.
And I guarantee you that if any of you NFL future Hall of Famers decide you want to climb in the ring at WrestleMania 11, you're going to be history because you'll have to deal with my corporation.
Let's go back and take a look at some of the outstanding action that went down in this one. Kid right on top of his game. Boy, he does some tremendous things. Look at that roundhouse. And he even had the privilege.
Oh, did you see that?
I did.
Of laying on top of Bam Bam Bigelow and getting a 1, 2, 3 count.
Yeah. You want to just rub it in, don't you, Gorilla?
Live event news when we come back.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Big Daddy Cool needs a big lift. I go for the big beef and spice. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jam.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in store soon.
It's here. Series 2 of Magic Works, Hidden Sun, Eye of the Pharaoh, Missing Masterpiece, Secret Slate, and more. Series 2 of Magic Works.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand. The WWF in high gear will be live at Madison Square Garden. We're in countdown time, New York. We are only 1 week out from one of the hottest afternoons in World Wrestling Federation action. Let me tell you, Big Daddy Cool Diesel and the bad guy from Miami, Razor Ramon, nothing can top their distaste for Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Double J Jeff Jarrett. Big Daddy Cool is anxious to get back to New York. As you told me earlier, Big Daddy Cool, how do you feel about returning to the Big Apple?
New York, New York, Madison Square Garden. That's right, where Big Daddy Cool won his gold. Last time there, Double J, me and you in the squared circle. Jackknife, baby, you lose. Rhodey interferes. He takes a big boot. And then Shawn Michaels is going to stick his nose in my business again and give me the super kick. That's right, 3-on-1. The scenario's been the same, hasn't it, before? Royal Rumble, 4-on-1. You know something, guys? It's time Big Daddy Cool evens the score. And what better way to do it than to have the bad guy, Razor Ramon, in my corner? That's right. I got me a partner. Madison Square Garden, you're going to see the fight of your life. And Michaels, after this one, you're not going to make it to Mania.
Big Daddy Cool definitely wants to get his hands on Shawn Michaels before Psycho Sid gets involved at WrestleMania 11, it sounds like. Now, The Undertaker will face off against Bam Bam Bigelow. Bret the Hitman Hart and the British Bulldog are teaming up against Owen Hart and Jerry the King Lawler. Bret the Hitman Hart, no doubt anxious to get into this tag team match. The explosive Adam Bomb will take on Mr. Bob Backlund in a submission match. And the Smoking Guns will take on Tatanka. And if you were watching Superstars yesterday, you saw me tell you that Kama is the newest member of the corporation. Kama and Tatanka will take on the Smoking Guns. Now, tickets are available at the box office and all Ticketmaster ticket locations. And WWF Fan Festival is just weeks away at this point. 7 sessions in all. You can choose anyone to attend. It's fully fan interactive. Call the numbers you see on your screens for more ticket information. But don't forget the WWF In High Gear Live at Madison Square Garden, Sunday, March 19th at a special start time of 2 p.m. Fabulous opportunity to bring the whole family on out to see all of our favorite superstars. This event is only 1 week from today.
Well, Gorilla Monsoon, 93,173 people in attendance. WrestleMania 3, that's over 8 years ago, back when Hulk Hogan was in his prime. They even had hair then.
Boy, he certainly did. It was the I Like Ike era, but they loved Hulk Hogan.
Hey,
oh, take a look at that.
Oh, that's disgusting. Wow. I tell you what, I like Henry style, but I can't say much for the bucket and the way he dresses.
Don't forget, folks, plenty of action still to come here this week. Lex Luger in action, along with the Bushwhackers and another corporate member, King Kong Bundy. And don't forget, a WrestleMania report with a Todster. I understand he's going to be laying some more WrestleMania 11 matches on us.
Well, I tell you what, Gorilla Monsoon, you have the gorilla vine. But I have the money line, and the money line tells me that one of the matches that Todster is going to be talking about at WrestleMania 11 is the Intercontinental title match between champion Double J Jeff Jarrett and former champion, the Greaseball himself, Razor Ramon.
Say what?
Double J is going to defend his title.
How do you know that?
Hey, money talks. Everybody's got a price, including Pettengill.
Henry here hammering away, and whoa, he was at Leroy, but Leroy now with a nice arm ringer going to work on the pink guy.
I'll tell you what, Gorilla Monsoon, you can say what you want to about Henry there, but since his since his matchup with The Undertaker, and even though he lost that match, the performance that he put in has elevated him in stature here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, it certainly has, but let's not forget that, look out here, that was an earnless Undertaker. Oh, wow, wow, what a shot.
Glad you mentioned that, Gorilla
Monsoon. Hung him out to dry on that clothesline, right on the top rope. He can get the pin right here. Oh, he jerked him up. Give me a break.
I like it. By the way, we're still investigating that urn.
You are?
Hey, I just can't figure it out.
Well, I understand that Nikolai's got it. Oh, look at that. Nikolai had it all figured out.
What do you mean?
Well, he was using it to warm up his chicken Kiev.
He was not.
That's what I heard. That's what the Gorilla Vine said.
Yeah, yeah. Well, the Gorilla Vine's not always right.
What's he looking for? Oh, he was scratching himself. Can you get this guy some flea powder?
I'll tell you what. You know, he dressed up real nice. You know, dress him up, cut his hair a little bit, get rid of that bucket, brush his tooth.
Brush his tooth.
Oh, brush his tooth.
One tooth, is that all he's got?
Yeah.
Give me a break.
He's got summer teeth.
Yeah, some are missing.
Yeah, some are green and some are missing.
Well, you know, what a clothesline by Godwin.
Ooh.
This guy's been hanging around a hog so much, he's starting to look like one of them.
Yeah, well, Leroy's having a bad day at the hand of him, no matter what he looks like.
Leroy getting hammered here this week. Just like perhaps Bam Bam will get hammered by LP.
Boy, you just can't stay away from it.
Can't do it because well, I can't wait till you are on one set. Ooh, nobody home on the elbow till you are 100% embarrassed.
Well, this is one time, Monsoon. You aren't going to get the last laugh.
Oh, Leroy put his head down and paid for it. Here's a slump drop.
Wow.
Good night, nurse.
There you go. A little root in there, Henry.
Oh, please. I can guarantee you there'll be a lot of rooting at WrestleMania 11 at the Hartford Civic Center 3 weeks Henry. From now for LT Lawrence Taylor. What's he hollering about now?
I don't know. Maybe he wants his bucket.
I'll tell you what, folks. Plenty more action still to come when we come back. Made in the USA, Lex Luger in action.
Many of you will remember me as Pierre de Quebecer. Why not? I am an extraordinary, gifted wrestler. Tout le monde le sait. But today, I come to you with a different story to tell. The year was 1815. The place was warm.
My great-great-grandfather was a legendary pirate. Gladly gave his ships, his men, his cannons, and his gold to defend America and the free world from hostile enemies. And what did he get in return? Insult. And banishment. Forced to roam the seven seas like a trench rat. So, I come to you today, the last living relative of the great John Lafitte. My true name, Jean-Pierre Lafitte. Soon, I will begin my revenge with the World Wrestling Federation. And when every sniveling superstar lies wallowing in their own tears of defeat, I will write my book on the entire universe. Beware the revenge of Jean-Pierre Lafitte!
This week, Wrestling Challenge is brought to you by Wrigley Spearmint Gum. When you can't smoke, it's pure chewing satisfaction.
Well, I wish you'd take a little bit and chew. Your breath is horrible.
Give me a break.
Too many bananas.
Oh, will you hear this ovation? There it is, the Stars and Stripes leading the way down for Made in the USA, Lex Luger.
Don't give him any chewing gum. He can't chew gum and walk at the same time.
Inside the squared circle.
Yeah, well, that's your opinion, Monsoon.
And a lot of people.
Some other people's opinions. But in my opinion, he's still trying to be a wrestler.
Well, how about guys like Ernie the Cat Ladd, Wahoo McDaniels, some of the greatest NFL players of all time? They were big superstars here in the World Wrestling Federation.
That's very true, bro, Monsoon, and I won't deny that. But they didn't take 3 or 4 weeks, a month, and climb into the ring with a seasoned veteran like Bam Bam Bigelow and become superstars and win a match. No, it took them a long time to achieve that transition. LT can't do it in 3 weeks.
Well, I don't think no one expects him to go out there and be throwing flying head scissors and moonsaults off the top turnbuckle.
Well, let me tell you this.
He's doing some things that your corporate members are not going
to
like.
Yeah, well, don't expect him to win, because if you're expecting him to win, you're going to be sadly mistaken.
Talk about a winning situation. Get this, DiBiase. 3 weeks from tomorrow, that's the night after WrestleMania on Monday, April 3rd at 7 p.m., the World Wrestling Federation Monday Night Raw returns to the Mid-Hudson Civic Center. And parents, here's your win for you. The World Wrestling Federation is going to give all children 12 and under tickets for half price. So bring the whole family down.
Yeah, all you cheapskates who want something for nothing, come on down. I don't have a money problem. I will be there, Grill Monsoon. That's for sure, because I will be basking in the glory of Bam Bam Bigelow, who will have just beaten Lawrence Taylor.
Boy, wishful thinking on your part. Alundra Blaze will be trying to get her ladies' title back from Bo Nakano and a whole host of other superstars here in the World Wrestling Federation. April 3rd. Oh, nice block and a reverse hip lock.
You really think Lawrence Taylor is going to do something to Bam Bam Bigelow, don't you?
I certainly do.
Why?
I also think that Lex is not done with Tatanka. I'm sure that he'll be catching up with him when the World Wrestling Federation once again gets into high gear.
Well, you want to know what? How many times has Lex Luger pinned and beaten Tatanka?
are too numerous to mention.
No. I can't think of it.
You can't. Oh, no.
But I can think of a couple times, and I can think of a couple times on national television where Lex Luger was beaten by my man.
Yeah, with or without corporate intervention.
Hey, we don't want to know how. We just want to know who.
Yeah,
and
sure.
It's good to talk about.
Mark Starr now dishing out a little offense of his own. Nice European-style uppercut. What is that, a tattoo on the back of his scapula there?
I'm not sure. I can't see that from here.
Good-looking youngster hammering away right now at the man made in the USA. And, well, just 3 weeks away, DiBiase. You're running out of time.
Running out of time, no. No, I'm afraid.
Oh, wow, what a clothesline.
It's LT who's running out of time.
And incidentally, talking about Lex doing numbers on guys from your corporation. Watch this. Power slam. Power slam, and we may see the rubber rack just like we may see it next week on Superstars when your guy King Kong Bundy could be caught up in this.
Yeah, well, Lex Luger, enjoy the glory while you can, because next week when you face King Kong Bundy, it's going to be one more time that you get embarrassed and humiliated by the corporation of the $1 million man.
This one is history. Let me ask you this, DiBiase. Will the entire corporation be in the corner of King Kong Bundy when he faces this man next week on Superstar?
Well, that's for me to know and you to think about, Gorilla Monsoon, but the corporation is on a roll. We will definitely be in the corner of Bam Bam Bigelow when he faces Lawrence Taylor. I'm going to start having some fireworks of my own for the corporation.
Take a look at that tremendous body.
Speaking of the corporation, you do notice that I have your services now.
I know that.
Yes, I do.
Supreme Fighting Machine.
That's right.
You need that and a whole lot more, I'm sure. Wendy Sheen with the stars and stripes. And hey, can you imagine how long this will live in her memory to be part of the World Wrestling Federation?
Oh, that's just wonderful. This touches my heart. You know, you said something about him picking up Bundy in the rubber wreck. You gotta be kidding, Monsoon. It's like picking up a small truck. He's strong, but he's not that strong.
Give me a break. Stay with us, folks. WrestleMania Report coming up.
Everybody, Todd Pettengill with your WrestleMania report. And believe it or not, we are just 3 weeks away from the most amazing night of the year. I'm talking about WrestleMania 11. The Grammys are big, the Oscars are bigger, and the Super Bowl blows them both away. But take all three events, roll them into one night, and you've got WrestleMania. The biggest superstars in the WWF and the hottest celebrities from New York to L.A. It's a spotlight, stretch limo, photo opportunity extravaganza. And it's presented by the originator in pay-per-view entertainment, the World Wrestling Federation. When you call your local cable company to place your order, make sure you ask for it by name. Otherwise, you never know what you're going to get. Tell the operator you want to see WrestleMania 11. It all happens Sunday night, April the 2nd, totally live from the sold-out Hartford Civic Center at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, and exclusively on pay-per-view. All right, let's get right into it and talk about the main event. The WWF Championship will be on the line as Big Daddy Cool Diesel defends the title against the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels with his new bodyguard, Sid. Certainly what Shawn Michaels lacks in size in this matchup, he more than makes up for in ability and protection in the form of the monstrous Sid. And true to form, Shawn Michaels is loving life, along with Pamela Anderson from the hit TV show Baywatch. You want to talk about a buzz? I mean, everybody is talking about this one everywhere. In fact, not since Ollie Frazier, not since Tyson Spinks, has the world been focused on a confrontation of this magnitude. Future NFL Hall of Famer Lawrence Taylor will actually step into the squared circle to face Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East. The word became official just 2 weeks ago at the WrestleMania press conference at the Harley-Davidson Cafe in Manhattan's New York City, the media capital of the world. As you can see here, a very classy handshake to set the deal in stone, but you better believe these two monsters will not be shaking hands at WrestleMania 11. Of course, earlier on, we saw Bam Bam Bigelow and the Million Dollar Corporation, who will all be on hand to watch Bam Bam's back at WrestleMania 11. And, of course, half the NFL in LT's corner. He has dubbed them his all-pro team. We're talking about Reggie White of the Green Bay Packers, Ricky Jackson and Ken Norton Jr. of the Super Bowl champion San Francisco 49ers, Steve McMichael, former Chicago Bear, now Green Bay Packer. How about this? A former teammate of LT's with the New York Giants, Carl Banks, who now suits up with the Cleveland Browns. Plus, all-pro Chris Spielman of the Detroit Lions. Can you imagine what it's going to look like when the cameras go off, the limos pull up, the agents and lawyers scurrying around talking to the media? This is going to be a night unlike any other. Now, let's talk about some of the other matches on the card for WrestleMania 11. You will see the unearthly Undertaker lock off with King Kong Bundy in what should be an incredible battle of power and brute force. Plus, as many of you heard last Monday night on Raw, the legendary Bret the Hitman Hart will meet his nemesis, Mr. Bob Backlund, in an I Quit match, which simply means the only way you lose is by saying the words, I quit. And frankly, those are words that the Hitman doesn't know the meaning of.
You know, for the past couple of months, I've had to live with this void in my life, and that void is not having the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt anymore. And you know, everybody has to come out sooner or later and face the fact that they lose. They lose a title. But you know something? I don't believe I ever lost that title. And when I look back at how it all happened, I go right back to you, Bob Backlund. Bob Backlund, I'll tell you what, we got ourselves a little rematch at WrestleMania. And in that rematch, it's an I Quit match. And in that I Quit match, Bob, I look forward to evening up the score. Bob Backlund, WrestleMania 11, you are going to find out that you will be excellently executed once and for all by the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. Bob Backlund, I'll see you in the ring.
Man, what a night this is going to be. You will also see the Intercontinental title go up for grabs as the new champion, Double J Jeff Jarrett, with the roadie in his corner, faces the former Intercontinental champion, the bad guy, Razor Ramon. Now, you're probably saying to yourself, man, this is going to be the greatest night ever, right? You're right, but I haven't even told you about the Hollywood hotshots who will also be on hand. Now, we mentioned Pamela Anderson from Baywatch. Obviously, she will be with Shawn Michaels for his title shot. You will also see NYPD Blues' Nicholas Turturro, who will be a guest ring announcer. You'll see Jonathan Taylor Thomas from Home Improvement and Man of the House, his new flick with Chevy Chase and Farrah Fawcett. You will see the beautiful Jennifer McCarthy from MTV, who will act as a guest timekeeper. I mean, the list of celebrities just continues to grow. And, of course, I will keep you updated in the weeks to come right here on the WWF Television Network. No question, this is as good as it gets. All right, folks, stay with us. There is more WWF action straight ahead. King Kong Bundy will be here. And coming up next, it's tag action with the Bushwhackers. Hi, this is Todd Pettengill bringing you a World Wrestling Federation Fan Festival Minute. The Fan Fest is sponsored by Tyco RC Maximum Heat. Tyco, makers of the hottest radio-controlled vehicles available today. The World Wrestling Federation Fan Festival will be held at the Hartford Civic Center Exhibition Hall from Friday, March 31st through Sunday, April 2nd. The Fan Festival is the experience of a lifetime, totally interactive, so you can experience the WWF in a hands-on style like never before. Now, my favorite part of the Fan Fest is the Dunk Doink Tank. Here's how it works. WWF superstar Doink the Clown is perched on a chair above a tank of water. Fans get to test their athletic skills by throwing a tennis ball at the target, which, when hit, will drop Doink into the drink. Doink seems to enjoy this more than anyone. Come down and see if you have a major league arm. It's the WWF Fan Fest. Tickets are on sale at the Hartford Civic Center box office at 203-525-4500.
Fan Festival is certainly going to be something else for WrestleMania 11, no question about it. The second annual DiBiase, as WrestleMania 10 at Madison Square Garden was its inauguration, and it's a tremendous event.
Yes, it is. It's going to be a lot of fun. I mean, hey, I'm going to go there. I can't wait to go to the Doink Tank.
Oh,
I'd like to dunk him. I'd like to knock him out.
Well, don't forget, you can also sit down and call a match with one of the announcers here in the World Wrestling Federation, or step into the funeral parlor I don't think you'd want to do that, would you?
No, no, I'm having trouble enough trying to figure out the urn.
Well, there'll also be a Hall of Fame booth with myself and Arnold Skolman and Freddy Blassie. You're not friends with Blassie Freddy? I thought you were.
That pistol neck geek.
Oh, great. Bushwhackers, of course, will be on hand as well at the fan festival, and autographs from the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation and a whole lot more.
Hey, what's that thing hanging around their neck called?
That's a hakuchi.
A what?
Well, it's not a TV. It doesn't have anything to do with hakuchi. It's a hatiki.
You got me confused now, Montrose.
Well, it doesn't take much to confuse you.
No.
You'll be a lot more confused after April 2nd. I got news for you.
Why is that? Now, here you go again. Well, you're just really convinced you think Bam Bam's going to get beat by LT. It ain't going to happen, Monsoon.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see, won't we?
Well, look at these guys. Take a look at that mug.
Look at the record book, DiBiase. Take a look at what these guys have done here in the World Wrestling Federation.
That's right. Stunk the place totally up.
They did not.
Well, smell them. Can't you smell that? Smells like a cross of tuna fish and sardines.
Hey, talking about the tag team situation coming up this Sunday on the Action Zone, Smoking Guns giving Men on a Mission a chance at the title.
The Smoking Guns had better look out. Men on a Mission, that's a pretty big team to face.
Well, it certainly is, but size doesn't mean everything, just like it won't mean everything at WrestleMania 11.
Boy, you just can't get off it, can you, Monster?
Boy, the entire world is talking about this, DiBiase. How do you expect me to get off it?
Yeah,
turn on the news anywhere, and there it is.
I know, I was there. Oh.
You know, I thought you'd be leaving. Why are you hanging around here? Don't you have to go back and get Bundy ready?
Yeah, I will.
A
minute.
You know, Bundy could have never made it in the National Football League. I don't think he could go for 60 minutes without putting something in his drum.
Come on, Monsoon. Give me a break. That's what halftime's for. You don't know what he can put away at halftime.
Oh,
but seriously, King Kong Bundy, if he'd have been in the National Football League, he'd be an all-pro player. He'd be like a refrigerator Perry.
Well, you know, some of you guys would have made some offensive stars, no question about it. Let's face it, most of the corporate members are offensive.
Okay, all right. 1,000 comedians in the country out of work, and you're trying to be one.
Tag made here, elbow drop, but nobody home. Incidentally, I'm sure King Kong Bundy not looking forward to meeting at WrestleMania 11, the Grim Reaper.
Well, we're going to have the urn figured out by WrestleMania 11. And The Undertaker, we're going to have a big surprise for him. You can count on it.
Irish whip and elbow. Bobby Baker flat on his back.
I'll tell you what, Gorilla Monsoon, Lawrence Taylor is going to be embarrassed so bad at WrestleMania by Bam Bam Bigelow. I guarantee you, Bam Bam's going to have him saying, Uncle, I give up. I quit. Don't hurt me anymore.
I'll tell you who's going to be embarrassed. This Monday night on Monday Night Raw, self-professed king Jerry Lawler will be embarrassed and humiliated by the excellence of execution Bret the Hitman Hart, just like he was in that big battle royal.
Yeah, well, we'll see about that. But I'll tell you where the Hitman's going to be embarrassed and humiliated. I was saying a couple minutes ago that Bam Bam was going to make LT quit. Well, at WrestleMania 11, it's going to be an I Quit match between the Hitman and Mr. Bob Backlund. Backlund is going to get the Hitman in the cross grace chicken wing, and he's going to be screaming, Uncle, I quit, Mr. Backlund, I quit.
Oh, wait a minute. Bobby Baker's going to be screaming, I quit right now. This one is indeed history.
Well, the one that's going to be screaming, I quit at this very moment is me, Gorilla Monsoon, because I'm tired of talking to you, and I'm going back in the back and get a real man, King Kong Bundy, ready for battle. See ya.
See if you can tear him away from the concession stand. Chalk up another one in the wins column for the Bushwhackers. And look, they're doing their thing. They've been licking and whacking their way through the World Wrestling Federation for how many years now? These guys are tremendous. Wouldn't be surprised if they got a shot at the reigning World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Smoking Guns. Why not? Look at that youngster. That's what the new generation is all about here in the World Wrestling Federation. And when we come back, we'll see King Kong Bundy.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Travel through the Stargate to a new dimension of gameplay featuring hostile enemies, high-tech gliders, and incredible morphing effects on Super NES, Genesis, Game Boy, and Game Gear from Acclaim.
Only Spidey's arachnid abilities and the Fantastic Four can stop 20 supervillains in the all-new Spider-Man video game. Also look for X-Men on home video.
as we are about to take a look at the biggest corporate member, King Kong Bundy. Of course, followed by the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, with that urn in hand. And it was, in fact, King Kong Bundy most responsible for getting the urn repossessed as he literally squashed the Undertaker. But to the best of my knowledge, they haven't figured out yet how to get the power from the urn, but it's obvious if you've seen the Grim Reaper of late, he's not the same man without that urn, no question about it. Tyrone Knox supplying the opposition here. How much will only take moments to tell, I'm sure.
But I'm the
million-dollar man. Well, if Bam Bam Bigelow is successful at WrestleMania 11 getting by the incomparable Lawrence Taylor, can you imagine what it would be like to have to live with him and the kind of publicity that that will bring to the corporation? Well,
it's just unbelievable.
Knox got hammered right from the get-go here by Bundy, not to my surprise. Ooh, wow! Vicious chop by King Kong Bundy. Knox got that right wrist and the left one, for that matter, wrapped very tightly. Could be some kind of former injury there.
Yes!
King Kong Bundy wants to shove him right outside and does, all the way down to the concrete floor here in the arena. Who wants to be next? Well, I've got a number of people in mind who would want to be next. King Kong Bundy will, in fact, at WrestleMania 11, April 2nd, face the Grim Reaper Undertaker. What a clothesline. Well, we'll see if, in fact, DiBiase brings the urn down to the ring for that match, whether the Undertaker will be able to use it or not. I know for a fact, Bundy just having a good time here at the expense of Tyrone Knox. So many great matches lined up. Well, he could have had the freak out there. For WrestleMania 11 as we kick off the second decade of WrestleMania. Of course, the main focus is being on Lawrence Taylor, superstar of the NFL, stepping in the ring against Bam Bam. But more importantly to me, Shawn Michaels, number one nemesis of World Wrestling Federation champion, Diesel. Well, you know, Shawn said he's taught Diesel everything that Diesel knows, but not everything that Shawn Michaels knows. Well, that remains to be seen. Tyrone here hasn't shown us any offense at all in this one. I think he got clobbered right from the get-go and hasn't got by that yet. And as long as he keeps staying in the corner like that, he's going to continue to get hammered. And how much punishment can you take from a guy like King Kong Bundy before the lights go out? Not a whole lot. A big smile and laugh, and look out! Oh, yes! That will do it, folks. He wanted a five count, but referee would not give it to him. He'll be very happy indeed if he can, in fact, at WrestleMania 11, get a three count. Just a simple 1-2-3, because not many people have been able to do that to The Undertaker.
The Tag Team Tournament. What would have happened if these two teams had met?
We would have beat you then, and we're going to beat you now and stay champions.
Who would have won?
During the tag team tournament, you were hurt, but now you got the belts, so now you got the mission.
Now they have a chance to find out.
We're taking those belts back to the ghetto, homeboy.
Yeah.
Men on a mission, just beware.
Men on a mission battle the smoking guns for the tag team title. This week on WWF Action Zone.
Many of you remember me as Pierre de Quebecer. But let me remind you that in truth, I am the great-great-grandson of the brave pirate, Jean Lafitte. There's only surviving heir, Jean-Pierre Lafitte. I wear this eye patch not because I cannot see Oh, no, no, mon ami. I wear the side patch. And the symbol of the blindness of all the American people. And especially the World Wrestling Federation. My great-great-grandfather gave all he had for your freedom. And you cast him aside. Like a still Muslim, I'm here to avenge that insult. And soon, the heroes of the World Wrestling Federation will know my revenge. The entire universe will tremble when they hear my name. Jean-Pierre Lafitte!
Well, what did you think of Pierre Lafitte, DiBiase?
Well, he sure had a lot to say, didn't he? Sounds like he's a little bit upset with everybody.
Well, listen to this tremendous ovation here for the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith.
Well, the Bulldog is making a big, big mistake.
What are you talking about? These two guys complement each other very, very well. Both similar training techniques, tremendous upper body power. Both great bands for their respective countries. What more would you want?
Listen, Gorilla, you got two classic examples of men with Cadillac bodies and Volkswagen brains tagging up. But the corporation still has an issue to settle with Lex Luger. Davey Boy Smith gets on the wagon with Lex Luger. He's biting off more than two because he's going against the corporation. Somewhere down the road, he'll pay for it.
Well, I'll tell you what, DiBiase, as far as I'm concerned, Lex and Davey will make one heck of a team, and they'll get tested and tested royally at WrestleMania 11 against Eli and Jacob Blue.
Tested? They're not going to get tested, Monsoon. They're going to get stopped right in their tracks. Eli and Jacob Blue, I've said it before, they are soon to be, I think, the next World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
Are you kidding, DiBiase?
No.
Are you saying that it's going to be easy pickings for Eli and Jacob against Lex and the Bulldog? Give me a break.
I didn't say it was going to be easy, Monsoon.
Well, I thought that's what you said.
I said they're going to get the job done.
I think you're just jealous because you know that Lex is a thorn in your side because, well, I know what you're thinking about, DiBiase. Here's a guy who made the transition from being a football star to a star here in the World Wrestling Federation, just like other guys like Ernie the Cat Ladd and Wahoo McDaniels and Lawrence Taylor.
Lawrence Taylor?
Well, you can't hear me.
Lex Luger, you said he's made the transition. In my mind, he's still attempting to.
Oh, please. Oh, nice series of move here by Donovan, but quickly reversed by the British Bulldog.
And LT, let me tell you what. No doubt that the guy is a great athlete, but he doesn't have time to come up to speed, to climb in the ring, and successfully face Bam Bam Bigelow. No way.
Well, I don't know. Oh, nice arm ringer here by Davey Boy. I don't know how you could... Well, formulate any kind of game plan because in my book, LT is a loose cannon, DiBiase, and it's going to explode right in your kisser.
Yeah, well, what do you think Bam Bam Bigelow is? You think Bam Bam Bigelow doesn't have just a little bit of, whatever you want to call it?
No, he's got a lot.
Yeah. I've got a game plan, Monsoon.
You mean Easter egg head?
All right, that's enough. I've got a game plan. I've matched up my team against LT's all-pro team, man for man.
You have?
That's right.
How can you do that? You guys are outnumbered.
Outnumbered? Don't worry about it. We've got the brain power.
You do?
Yeah. Number one, they're big man, big all-pro, Reggie White, Green Bay Packers. King Kong Bundy is going to watch him.
Reggie will run around him off. Are you kidding?
Hey, once Bundy gets his hand on him.
Look out! Oh, wow!
Right there, Monsoon. That's exactly what Bundy's going to do to Reggie White. King Kong Bundy is an offensive line that Reggie White hasn't faced yet.
Well, now that you talk about it, most of your corporate members are offensive, aren't they?
Oh, all right. Another comedian, continuously trying to be a comedian. Get serious, Monsoon.
Chick Donovan here, better show us some offense here, or Davey Boy's going to end this one very quickly. Well, he's reverting to some unorthodox strategy right now.
Well, he better get a totally different strategy He made a bad choice teaming up with Luger.
Oh, look at this abdominal stretch. Well, let's face it here. Kid Donovan looks good, but not wrapped too tight, I don't think.
Yeah.
Look at that power out there by the British Bulldog.
Hey, you know, the Bulldog would have been a great football player.
Ooh, hard in the corner.
They think soccer is football.
Well, it is. Oh, here comes the patented running slam of the British Bulldog. Lights out time for Mr. Donovan.
Wow.
Just like that, it's over.
Yeah, well, enjoy it while you can, Bulldog. What we see in that at WrestleMania.
Chalk up another win for the British Bulldog. Up next, the boy toy.
What I do is go out there, thrill people, excite people beyond belief. And WrestleMania 11 will be no exception. Big Daddy Cool, I suggest you fill both gas tanks and be ready to throw it into overdrive, because the Heartbreak Kid is hot, on fire, and ready to go. And fans, I guarantee you beyond a shadow of a doubt, I will give you a show like you have never, ever seen before. Why? Because I can.
Welcome back, everyone, and the music indicates only one person is headed to the ring right now. It is the man who claims that destiny will be fulfilled 2 weeks from now on April 2nd, and he will become the reigning World Wrestling Federation champion, Shawn Michaels.
And I believe, Gorilla Monsoon, that he will. And take a look at his insurance policy, Big Bad Sid.
Well, it's going to be awful crowded in Shawn Michaels' corner at WrestleMania, because Sid will be there along with Pamela Anderson and, hey, maybe Pamela's husband.
Tommy Lee, not a chance. He won't be there at all.
What a blockbuster it's going to be, WrestleMania 11. Don't you dare touch that remote. We'll be right back.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
There are two kinds of snacks. One's for wimps and punks, and the other's for me. You need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in store soon.
Preferred Stock, the extra smooth cologne for an extra special man. Preferred Stock, what preferred men prefer. From the House of Stetson.
Boy, oh boy, look at the way Sid towers over Shawn Michaels.
Psycho Sid, that's what he calls himself, Gorilla Monsoon. An added insurance policy for Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 11.
Well, at WrestleMania 11, oh, look at this. Hunter not wasting any time here. Wants to get all the advantage he can, and he'll need every bit of it. Too hard into the corner.
Charlie Hunter making a big mistake jumping on Shawn Michaels at the end of the match. He will definitely pay for that right now.
Oh, look at that. Wow.
I'm telling you, Gorilla, Shawn Michaels always comes through with a spotlight.
Oh, 360, and Charlie's out of there.
And without a doubt, at WrestleMania 11, the spotlight will be centered on Shawn Michaels.
Oh, look at him. Oh. Holy mackerel.
Like I said, Charlie's going to pay. The spotlight will be on Shawn Michaels like it has never been before. And indeed, he will come through. I am guaranteeing that he will become the next World Wrestling Federation champion.
Well, I guess he's not depending on you, DiBiase. He's depending on that guy right there with the 60-inch chest, Psycho Sid.
All Sid is insurance that nobody interferes in this match. I guarantee you, Shawn Michaels can beat Diesel on his own merit.
Oh, look at this. All the way up to the top here, Shawn Michaels. Well, here's our exclusive double feature replay. Action that went down moments ago, and action that's going on right now. But remember this, DiBiase, at WrestleMania 11,
up,
just as Sid dwarfed Shawn Michaels earlier on.
Oh, There's that super kick, Gorilla.
It's over.
It's all over. And that's what you're going to see at WrestleMania 11. Shawn Michaels took out the Bulldog with the super kick cannonball, and he took out Diesel three times. And I'm predicting at WrestleMania 11 it's going to be a four-peat.
Huh. Clearing out the ring, Psycho. What do you mean took him out three times?
That's his Achilles heel. Diesel's Achilles heel is the super kick.
Please. What a matchup it's going to be. Just 2 weeks away now to April 2nd, WrestleMania 11. What an event this is going to be. When we come back, head shrinkers,
being afraid of any man. You know, only thing I'm afraid of is probably snakes and alligators. I don't see any snakes and alligators in Bam Bam. I see pussycats. I think on a good day I can take Bam Bam.
Welcome back, everyone. Well, Lord Taylor talking about having a good day. DiBiase, when was the last time the corporation had a good day?
Let me tell you something, Gorilla Monsoon. You heard what he said. I heard what he said. He thinks he can beat Bam Bam on a good day. Well, he better be having his best day if he thinks he's going to beat Bam Bam Bigelow. It didn't sound like he was sure to me.
Well, sounded pretty confident to me. We're looking at the head shrinkers here under the tutelage of Captain Lou Albano and, of course, Agua, who are going to Fatu and Cioni. In my opinion, odds-on favorite somewhere down the road to get their hands on the tag title.
Well, I can't dispute that, Gorilla Monsoon. Obviously, one of the great teams in the World Wrestling Federation. The Smoking Guns have certainly got their work cut out. I can't say that I agree with what they've done now. They have finally said they're going to put the titles up against Owen Hart and a mystery partner.
At WrestleMania.
At WrestleMania. You never go into a match, especially at WrestleMania, defending your title against a team where you don't know who half the team is. That's not very smart at all.
They're great athletes. Nobody said they were any, Einsteins.
Yeah, well, they're certainly not. I think that when the horse fell on Bart, it must have fell on his head because you're not thinking very clearly. Either that or they're much too overconfident themselves.
Barry Horowitz starting it off here against Cioni, and Horowitz not lacking any confidence either with that little pat on the back.
And what about what Lawrence Taylor said last week? Gonna go out there like a bunch of crazed dogs and have some fun.
What's wrong with that?
If he thinks he's gonna be having fun at the expense of Bam Bam Bigelow, he better think again. And as far as being a crazed dog, well, this is one time, LT, that your bark's a little bigger than your bite.
Let me ask you something, DiBiase. At WrestleMania 11, how are you going to account for Chris Spielman?
Chris Spielman?
Yeah.
I'm going to put the talk on him.
Oh, please.
That's right.
Oh, nice European-style uppercut there by Barry Horowitz off the ropes here. Wow, ducked underneath that one. Oh, he didn't duck underneath that one, no.
And as long as you asked, there's another great big guy over there, another one of those Green Bay Packers, Steve McMichaels.
Yes.
Yeah, well, I got comma watching him. How you like that?
Huh? Well, maybe you could get a little insight as to what LT's going to... Oh, look at that. Double headbutt there. Hey, DiBiase, you know... Lawrence Taylor, of course, under the tutelage and under the weight of Diesel, but I understand there's a good possibility those workouts could go public.
Public, huh?
Yeah.
Well, you can be guaranteed of one thing. I'll be having spies out there, and he might as well have public workouts so he can shine while he can, because once the bell rings at WrestleMania 11, he won't be doing any shining.
Come on!
As a matter of fact, a couple of NFL football teams that should be looking for some new defensive players next year. They're going to be in dire need of help.
Hey, did you give him my hot dog?
No.
Oh, wow, what a shot.
Unlike you, Monsoon, I believe he buys his own.
Oh, please.
Yeah.
I spend more money accidentally than you do on purpose. Look at him trapped in the corner. Brooklyn Brawler about to get hammered here.
That's why I'm the million-dollar man and you're not.
Yeah, because you never spend any money.
Well... He looks like he's enjoying that dog.
Fatu having a good time, and Cioni waiting anxiously in the corner, and Appa always has a good time.
Yeah, quit licking your lips. It looks like he made you hungry.
Oh, look at the elevation on that backdrop.
Steve McMichaels, one of the biggest men in the NFL. Reggie White, another big man. But you know what? Nobody.
Who DDT?
In the NFL, is any bigger than any of the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, that's
matter
true.
Of fact, all of those guys have to literally look up.
Well, I'll tell you what. While your guys are looking down, you better be looking out. Look at this. Second turnbuckle on the inside. Cioni just waiting. And the setup is made. And, oh, good night. You know, DiBiase, you've told us how all your corporate members are going to be sort of paired off in your game plan, but you never mentioned Nikolai.
You mean, who's Nikolai going to be watching?
Well,
I'm not going to have him watching anybody. He has a hard enough time taking care of himself.
You well, know you I mean? Got that right. Nikolai can't even figure out how to get the lid off the earth.
Now, Wait a minute. Don't worry about Nikolai. He's a good, faithful servant. But on the other hand, there's two gentlemen that I'm going to personally watch. Ricky Jackson and Carl Banks. They're mine.
Oh, boy. Look out! Barry Horowitz right for the pickets here. Headshrinkers do this move so effectively. Oh, good.
See you, Barry.
It's all over but Gashani. Well, I'm looking forward to see another big matchup on the Action Zone this weekend. Bam Bam taking on Doink.
Well, this is one time that Doink won't be getting the last laugh, Gorilla Monsoon. But let's take a look at what just took place here in this match. There you have Sione going off the second turnbuckle. Bam! Barry Horowitz, there you go. And then there's the patented Samoan splash. And this one is all over.
Hey, maybe Dink will have the last slam.
Not a chance.
Paranoid Backlund when we come back.
It was an assault. It was a battery. That fallacious plebeian of your society. He has a constant tendency to relapse into barbarianism. And he proved it the way he stole my belt. Yes, my belt. It was one of the biggest travesties that ever occurred. Matter of fact, it superseded any crime in this century. And I'm here to confront the judicial system because of the amoral attitude that they project to your society. Are you listening to me?
He just doesn't quit, does he?
Not my problem anymore. I'm out of here.
You're not just going to leave him here.
Yeah, I got a plane to catch. I'm off to WrestleMania.
Aww.
I am a victim, and I will not capitulate until the judicial system does something about this new generation.
Well, take a good look. Paranoid Bob Backlund. Well, he did a pretty smart thing here. Did you see what went down?
Yes, he went down.
Well, he inadvertently got Double J to sign a title match for the Intercontinental Championship, and then he grabbed the contract and put his own name on it. Somewhere down the road, that match is going to happen.
So maybe he only appears to be out there in left field.
He's not as dumb as he looks.
Exactly.
You know, I don't know whether that's going to happen before or after WrestleMania, but if it happens before WrestleMania, well, Bob Backlund could walk into that I Quit match as the reigning Intercontinental Champion.
That's right, and that would mean he would be defending the title against Bret the Hitman Hart, who, if the Hitman beat Backlund, he'd be the winner of the Intercontinental title three times over, right?
Well, there's an awful lot of ifs there.
A lot of ifs.
It's like if you could get by the All-Pro team.
Well, I don't think you can, but no.
That's a really bad hit.
That's ludicrous. Monsoon, like I said before, the NFL is going to be looking for a few new defensive players on a couple of teams next season. You know what I mean?
I know exactly what you mean, but get this, DiBiase. 2 weeks from this Monday night Raw will rock the Mid-Hudson Civic Center on Monday, April 3rd. That's the day after WrestleMania.
That's the day of celebration for the corporation, and we will be there in force. Bam Bam will be there, Tatanka, King Kong Bundy, and yours truly, of course.
Well, either that or you'd be hanging your head in shame,
not
right?
Not a chance. Not a chance.
What is this? A mirror image here by Bob Backlund. Don't forget, folks, 2 weeks from this Monday night Raw in the Mid-Hudson Civic Center. Backlund with a nice leverage move there, DiBiase, on the pink and blue attired Major Yate. How do you ever become a major?
I don't know, but maybe Backlund has vision of Bret the Hitman Hart. There's a guy in pink and black, and he's got to be thinking back to when he had Bret Hart in the submission match at Survivor Series. That's where the Hitman lost the title.
Yeah, but he didn't quit.
Yes, he did.
He did. No,
I heard him. He was screaming and crying like a baby.
It was Hamilton threw the towel in. What's wrong with
you? Well, because he saw our son and breathing the pain and screaming, I quit, I quit, I quit.
Oh, he never once said I quit.
Well.
Why are you telling these lies, D.B.?
I wouldn't lie.
Well, they're chanting in unison here, Opie, and Bob Backlund doesn't like it.
Take a look. Yes, he does. And I think the Hitman, he's in big trouble.
You do, huh?
Yes, I do.
Well, I got news for you. I personally feel it's Shawn Michaels who's going to be in big trouble at WrestleMania 11. Oh, look at this. Backlund got slammed here by Yates.
You know, how could you think that Shawn Michaels is going to be in big trouble?
Have you seen the determination, the look on the face of Diesel? Give me a break.
How soon you forget that it was Shawn Michaels, along with his super kick, that has already knocked Diesel out three times. You might say, like I said before, the super kick is the Achilles heel of the mighty Diesel.
Well, who's the champion?
Diesel.
Well, case closed.
Case closed. Say that after WrestleMania 11.
No, I'll probably say it.
I'll say it. It'll be Shawn Michaels.
Oh, look at that nice series of moves there by Backlund.
Yeah!
Oh, he may be setting them up here for the dreaded chicken wing crossface. And, of course, he says he will not turn the hole loose until the opponent says, I, in fact, do quit, Mr. Bob Backlund.
Well, he's going to hear it one more time, just like he did.
He won't hear from Brett, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. We'll put a little wager on it.
Well, I've been known to make a wager occasionally.
Yes, you have.
Oh. Nice shoulder block by Backlund. Yates up quickly, though. Oh, single leg trip.
You know, back to my plan. You know, I do have a plan for WrestleMania 11.
Get out of town as quick as possible.
I've talked about the fact that Bundy's going to cover Reggie White. Tama's going to watch Steve McMichael. Tatanka's on Chris Spielman. And I'm personally going to watch Ricky Jackson and Carl Banks. And there's one more. Ken Norton Jr., San Francisco 49ers.
Who's going to watch him?
IRS.
Oh, please. Do you honestly think that all these corporate members are going to remember all that, DiBiase?
Of course they are.
You better have written it down.
Don't worry. I told you. I've got a strategy.
Side headlock here by Backlund. Yates wants out in the worst way. Put his head down prematurely.
Yeah, well.
Look out!
Brett the Hitman Hart is going to want out in a bad way.
Atomic drop and a beauty.
Out of the cross face.
And now here comes. Setting him up.
Yes, we are. He's going to do it.
Look at him sneaking up.
Look at the look on his face.
Wow. He's gone. There it is. He doesn't have it cinched in yet. Well, now he does. It's locked up.
And
I'm going to hear this.
Major Yates is gone.
Did he say it? I didn't hear him say it.
Here is owner.
Doesn't look like he's
caught right now.
What happened?
I heard that. I heard that.
What happens if he renders him unconscious before he can say, I quit?
Well, then you're at the mercy of the referee. And, of course, Paranoid Bob, and nobody would want to be stuck in that position. Look, he's not turning it loose. The guy already quit. Give me a break.
He's enjoying this.
He certainly is.
So am I. Look at that. Look at the look on his face.
Gone. He's lost it completely.
That doesn't look like Opie Taylor to me.
Boy, it certainly does not. He's enjoying every minute of this, talking about it, enjoying things. Everyone will enjoy themselves at the second annual Fan Fest. I'll tell you what, it's coming up very shortly. 2 weeks and counting.
This is Stephanie Wyan bringing you a World Wrestling Federation Fan Festival Minute. The Fan Fest is sponsored by Tyco RC Maximum Heat. Tyco, makers of the hottest radio-controlled vehicles available today. The World Wrestling Federation Fan Festival will be held at the Hartford Civic Center Exhibition Hall from Friday, March 31st through Sunday, April 2nd. The Fan Festival is the experience of a lifetime. It's interactive, so you can experience the WWF in a hands-on style like never before. How many times have you dreamed of getting an autograph from your favorite superstar? Well, that dream can come true because the Fan Festival has three autograph areas, all sponsored by Connecticut's Foxwoods Resort Casino. Imagine getting a personal note from Lex Luger or receiving best wishes from Razor Ramon. You can get to see just how great Jeff Jarrett really is. Plus, there are plenty of other fantastic exhibits for the entire family to enjoy. So make sure to come and don't forget to bring a camera. Tickets are on sale now at the Hartford Civic Center box office and at all Ticketmaster locations in the Northeast. Just call 203-525-4500.
Buddy, Todd Pettengill with your WrestleMania report, and I gotta tell you folks, the sands of time are running out quicker than they did in the Witch's Hourglass in the Wizard of Oz.
And it's almost time, my pretty, for WrestleMania 11.
There are only 2 weeks left till we hit the sold-out Hartford Civic Center. I'm talking Sunday night, April the 2nd, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, exclusively on pay-per-view television. Now, you've got to call your local cable company and place your order for WrestleMania 11. And when you do, please ask for it by name. We wouldn't want you to get something with less firepower. Because you know, when the WWF throws a party, it is first class all the way. WrestleMania is the biggest night of the year. We're talking limos with hot tubs, photographers from all over the world, bigger than the Oscars and the Grammys rolled into one. More action than the Super Bowl or Game 7 of the World Series when they used to play that game. WrestleMania is the biggest of them all. Allow me, if you would, to run the entire card of action for this year's biggest night as we enter our second decade of the new WWF generation. Let's begin with the WWF title match. The champion, Big Daddy Cool Diesel, puts the gold on the line when he meets his former friend, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels. Big Daddy Cool has had an incredible reign as champion and has put fear in the hearts of many superstars in the WWF. However, Shawn Michaels has a little insurance policy in his hip pocket, his new bodyguard, Sid. And he also has one of Hollywood's biggest stars on his arm. None other than Pamela Anderson from the hit series Baywatch.
Oh, my. Would you look at that beautiful, gorgeous waistline on Pamela Anderson. But you know something, Pammy, baby? The Heartbreak Kid's got a pretty lean, mean waistline himself.
Yeah, well, you're a little gutless.
Oh, but honey, the waistline of the Heartbreak Kid's going to be getting just a little bit bigger come WrestleMania. You want to know why? I'm going to tell you anyway because I know you want to know. Because the Heartbreak Kid come WrestleMania is going to be strapping the World Wrestling Federation title around this sleek waist.
Well, I know Pam just got married recently, and it looks as if she may be growing a little tired of the cocky Heartbreak Kid. All right, here's one for the record books, folks. A matchup that has captured the hearts and minds of people all over the world. The Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow, has indeed enticed future NFL Hall of Famer Lawrence Taylor into the squared circle. You can't go anywhere without reading about it or hearing about it. Man, LT's going to slay the Beast, or Bigelow's a veteran. It's going to be great, man. People are talking about it all over. Everybody has an opinion about this one. And to make things even more interesting, LT will be escorted down the aisle by the hip-hop rap duo of Salt and Pepper.
Word.
And will be backed up by his all-pro team. Check out this hit squad. Reggie White of the Green Bay Packers, Ricky Jackson and Ken Norton of the Super Bowl champion San Francisco 49ers, Steve McMichael, former Chicago Bear, now Green Bay Packers, Carl Banks, a former teammate of Lawrence Taylor's in New York, now a Cleveland Brown, and Chris Spielman, all-pro for the Detroit Lions. Now, on the other side of the canvas square, Ted DiBiase and the whole million-dollar corporation, Tonka, King Kong Bundy, Kama, IRS, and Nikolai Volkov. Man, who knows what's going to happen when the Beast meets the Giant at WrestleMania. You will also see the legendary hitman Bret Hart square off against the unpredictable and dangerous Mr. Bob Backlund in an I Quit match. You win an I Quit match by getting your opponent to say, I quit. And that's the only way you can win, which means certainly anything is likely to happen. In addition, at WrestleMania 11, you will witness an intercontinental title match between Double J Jeff Jarrett with the ever-present Rhodey and the bad guy Razor Ramon. Now, it certainly is no secret that these guys have quite a colorful past, and we know what Double J, Jeff Jarrett, and the Rhodey are capable of. Can the bad guy reclaim the Intercontinental Gold? We will find out together, Chico. In another matchup, folks, it's the mighty King Kong Bundy battling The Undertaker. Now, the quickness and stamina of The Undertaker against the raw power and size of King Kong Bundy. But there's still more. How about some tag action for you? Two good friends, Lex Luger and the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, will team up to take on Jacob and Eli Blue. In another tag match, you will see the champion Smoking Guns battle Owen Hart and a mystery partner. Owen Hart has made it very clear he will not say who his partner is till WrestleMania. And believe me, the rumors and speculation are everywhere. Add to that incredible card some of the hottest celebrities in the world. We already, of course, mentioned Pamela Anderson from Baywatch. You will also see NYPD Blues' Nicholas Turturro, who will be a guest ring announcer. I mean, it doesn't get much bigger than that, does it? Well, we've got Jonathan Taylor Thomas, who plays Randy on ABC's Home Improvement. He did the voice of Simba in The Lion King. He'll be a guest broadcaster. We've also signed the incredibly beautiful and talented Jennifer McCarthy from MTV, who will serve as a guest timekeeper. And in the short time remaining, I'll have more names of celebrities who will be hanging in Hartford for WrestleMania 11, just 2 weeks away. I'm talking Sunday night, April the 2nd, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, totally live from the sold-out Hartford Civic Center. Please, whatever you do, ask for WrestleMania by name when you call your local cable company. Don't be fooled by imitators. We are the innovators. It's WrestleMania from the World Wrestling Federation.
Hello.
Hello?
Jenny? Hi, it's Bill. Listen, I was wondering if you happen to have the time.
Yeah, it's 2:19 a.m.
Well, good luck at WrestleMania. Thank you so much.
Sure, anytime.
MTV's Jennifer McCarthy, official timekeeper, WrestleMania 11. Paid for by the following.
True Lies explodes onto your favorite video game system. It's up to you to battle fanatical terrorists and save the world from nuclear destruction from a plane.
Only Spidey's arachnid abilities and the Fantastic Four can stop 20 supervillains in the all-new Spider-Man video game. Also look for X-Men on home video.
When Big Daddy Kool needs a big lift, I go for the big beef and spice. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jam!
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyan. Well, at 2 p.m. today, the hottest event that New York has ever seen, WWF in High Gear, live at Madison Square Garden. It's happening. You still can get a ticket, 212-307-7171. Big Daddy Cool Diesel and the bad guy Razor Ramon will take on Shawn Michaels and Double J Jeff Jarrett. Now, Big Daddy Cool and the bad guy have definitely had their problems. If you saw them at the Garden battling over the Intercontinental Championship, you know these men stop at nothing to get what they want. How will they work together as a team? Well, I do have the Big Daddy Cool man standing by himself. Big Daddy Cool, speak your mind.
Madison Square Garden, that's right. In a few short hours, the bad guy and myself, Big Daddy Cool, are going to take care of business. Punks, put up or shut up. You know, you guys been running your mouth, interfering, 3-on-1, 2-on-1. Me and the bad guy, we're sick of it. Madison Square Garden's seen a lot of battles, but this one will top them all. In a few short hours, the explosions will hit. And I tell you something, people, you won't want to miss this one.
Well, of course you don't want to miss it. Can you imagine what would happen if you did? Now, this event is just over an hour away. You can still call Ticketmaster, though. 212-307-7171. And hey, if you don't want to do that, you can walk to the box office. Now, The Undertaker will meet Bam Bam Bigelow in the squared circle. How many members of the corporation will Bam Bam bring along? And hey, The Undertaker wants you, the Creatures of the Night, to be there so he can get his earn back. Bret the Hitman Hart and British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith will take on Owen Hart and Jerry the King Lawler. Oh, Bret wants this match so bad. Not only have Owen and Jerry the King Lawler humiliated the Hart family, insulting Stu and Helen, but Lawler's accused the Hitman of being a racist. The man is crazy. He wants vengeance, and he wants it today. Let me tell you, all together, though, we have 8 gigantic matches, blockbusters, all of them. You can still get your tickets. They're available at the box office and all Ticketmaster ticket centers. Call 212-307-7171. It is Madison Square Garden today, 2 p.m. Great time to bring the family out. Can you imagine what would happen if you missed it? You may miss the matches of the century, the matches that could change the face of WrestleMania history forever. WrestleMania 11, blah, 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 done. Not the way we thought it would be. Today, the Garden, 2 p.m. You better be there.
Revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Billion Dollar Man Ted DiBiase, just 1 week and counting to the big one,
WrestleMania 11, and we're waiting for Men on a Mission, who DiBiase we haven't seen in a couple of weeks on the Action Zone. We saw them. They lost control. They lost it completely and hammered a smoking gun.
Lost control. It's the first time I've seen Men on a Mission take the initiative. I think those two guys have finally realized that good guys, nice guys finish last.
Yeah, but last week on the Zone, didn't you hear Oscar make the apology?
Yeah, you heard Oscar make an apology. What they did speaks for itself. I want to deeply, deeply apologize to all you fans, and especially to the smoking guns, for what we did at the end of the match. To be a tag team champion is every person's aspiration in the World Wrestling Federation, and when we thought we won the match, we were disappointed. So therefore, Mabel and Mo were a bit overzealous. And for that, I'm sorry. The smoking guns, we hold them in high regard. They homeboys of ours. We'll never do it again. And once again, we apologize.
Well, there you have it, DiBiase. How about that? Right out of the mouth of Oscar.
Give me a break,
Oscar. That's a big man, you know, to stand up and apologize. He's that national apology, something you would never do.
He's not speaking for Men on a Mission. He's speaking for himself.
Did you not hear him say, we?
I heard what he said, but let me tell you something. Actions speak louder than words, and what you saw Men on a Mission do to smoking guns tells you how they really feel. They ought to get rid of Oscar. He's like dead weight, dead luggage. Get rid of him, and they do a lot more. They go a lot farther in the World Wrestling Federation.
You think so?
Yes, I know so.
Well, Ken Raper and Gary Sabaugh supplying the opposition here this week for Men on a Mission, and Mo looks to be bulking up a little bit.
Yes, indeed. I'm going to tell you something. What I saw from Men on a Mission, what they did to the smoking guns, showed me a little frustration, showed me that they're finding out.
Boom! Look at that power display by Mo.
That being nice guys in the World Wrestling Federation doesn't get the job done. I think that they've got what it takes if they'll just forget about all this fans and just clapping and cheering, get rid of Oscar and go on their own. They'll
Irish
go a long
whip
way.
Here by Cannon. Whoa, wow, Mabel, or Mo just ran him right over. Looks like they perhaps stole a page out of your playbook, DiBiase.
And what's wrong with that?
Slam and a beauty here by Mo. Raper in a whole lot of trouble here. Ooh, wow, needs to get over and make a tag.
Speaking of people in a whole lot of trouble, LT, 1 week away, LT. You're going to set records, all right. You're going to be able to go and hide in a corner. That's about all after WrestleMania 11.
Tag made here. Big Mabel stepping over the top rope of Do-Si-Do. And around we go. Look out.
Oh.
Ooh. Raper in a whole heap of trouble. Ooh. Gary Sabaugh yet to get into this one. Oh, look at this. All the way up top.
What LT's gonna look like. That's WrestleMania 11 right there.
Yeah.
Well, that's wishful thinking on your mind.
Him and that entire all pro team he's bringing.
Yeah, you wish, DiBiase. You're gonna have your hands full. We may have an additional match at WrestleMania 11, and it could be a big Royal Rumble.
It's gonna be a dying run. If they decide to climb in that ring, they're gonna be in a whole new world, and they're not gonna like it.
Well, nice ovation here for Men on a Mission. After what they did to Smoking Guns 2 weeks ago in the Action Zone, I didn't expect this kind of reception.
Give me a break. Shut him. Will somebody shut him up?
Stop the music, please.
Oh, no. Wait a minute. Mabel wants to say something. Maybe he's going to make an apology, too.
No.
First of all, hi, Charleston. How are you? Last week, Men on a Mission came out. We had a championship match with the Smoking Guns. A great match. We lost the match, and we got a little upset. A little overzealous. We sort of did something we shouldn't have done.
Oh, come on.
What I want to do right now, I know the Smoking Guns are in the back. They're watching the monitor as I speak. I want to say, Billy and Bart, if you would please come out here into the ring so me and my partner Mo can make a public apology.
All right.
I'll
in front of
set.
You guys and all these good fans in Charleston, South Carolina.
I told you so, didn't I?
Oh. So Billy and Vaughn, please, if you would, come down to the ring.
I told you that Oscar was speaking for everybody.
This is making me sick. I can't believe this.
Well, once again, you're going to have to say hats off to the entire team of Men on a Mission now. And there's Billy and Bart, World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, coming down to accept apology right out of the mouth of Mabel and Mo.
Well, I still say it's Oscar's influence. If they get rid of Oscar, they'd be a lot better off.
What's wrong with that kind of influence?
It's terrible.
Come on, guys. Please. There's nothing to fear.
Oh, man, this is disgusting.
Billy.
Just keep quiet.
Bart, I want to speak for me, Oscar, and Mo.
Give me a crying towel.
And say, guys, we're sorry for what happened last week. In my opinion, I think you guys are the greatest World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion of all time.
Oh, man.
It's a big man to say
that. Come on, give it up for him.
Well, the best champions of all time.
These guys deserve those belts.
Me and IRS.
They have paid their dues.
Oh, they're loving it here.
Yeah.
So right now,
glad somebody is.
Bart, I want to say from the bottom of my heart, guys.
A big heart.
I'm sorry. Good luck in the rest of your career.
Well, why don't you just go ahead and kiss him?
Please shake our hands, please.
Oh, man.
Oh, yes. True sportsmanship, that's what it's all about here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, isn't that sweet?
Boy, I'd love to see that. Well, we've got a whole blockbuster card lined up for you here this week.
Oh, hey.
Wait a minute.
Look at that.
Give me a break.
I knew it, Monsoon. I knew it. I told you.
Oh, no.
I told you so, Monsoon.
This is despicable.
This is fantastic.
I don't believe this.
Now that's championship caliber there. Now these guys, I told you they had it. I told you they had it, Monsoon. I was right.
Billy and Bart fell down on a canvas, obviously hurt, with WrestleMania just a week away when they had... Oh, no. Look at Oscar. Oscar's sincere. Look at the look. Oh, no. They're turning on Oscar.
Oh, I love it. I love it. That's right. Get rid of him. Look at this, Monsoon. They're going to splash in.
Oh, no. This is ridiculous!
Oh, do it again.
Men on a Mission.
Do it again.
Obviously showing their true colors here.
I love it. Hey, I couldn't have done this better myself.
I don't believe what I've seen here this week.
Well, see it and believe it. Men on a Mission have truly seen the light. They've come around.
And folks, in just 1 week, take a look. Billy and Bart hurt. They have to defend at WrestleMania 11 against, well, the Rocket King, Owen Hart, and his mystery partner, whoever that may be. I'm not sure that that's going to happen.
The smoking guns have never looked better.
Oscar is out cold.
Yeah.
Come on, let's get some help.
Now he's got his hat on.
That's sick.
Unbelievable. Fantastic. Hey, Monsoon, I told you so. You got to admit it. I was right. Go ahead, admit it. You got to admit it. I was right with you. I was right.
I won't admit it. You were just as surprised as everybody else, Stevie.
Oh, but I was pleasantly surprised. I told
Thumbs
you that.
Thumbs down indeed for Men on a Mission. You know, sooner or later, you're going to have to pay for something. Look at that. Talk about getting sucker punched.
And Oscar, I told you they had to get rid of the excess luggage, and they have.
I wouldn't be surprised, DiBiase,
Let's go
straight to the top, taking no prisoners. Everybody, beware. We're a new generation.
Bad news. Well, the arena's still buzzing about what went down only moments ago as we hear the music that tells us that the Rocket King Owen Hart himself is on his way.
You know, just to show you, Monsoon, that I'm not all bad, I'm gonna give Oscar a gift.
What is that?
A new set of Hartman luggage.
Oh, boy.
Get packing, buddy. I love it.
Be interesting to see. I sent someone back in the locker room area to see what kind of injuries possibly Smoking Guns sustained as
Let's face it, it's only a week now before WrestleMania 11, and they're going to have to get in there and defend their titles. They might be hurt.
They might be hurt. Not only they might be hurt, they're going to lose. They got to go up against the man we're looking at right now, the King of Hearts, Owen Hart, and a missing partner. Now, I always know what's going on, Monsoon, and I can't even tell you who Owen Hart's partner is going to be at WrestleMania 11.
Yeah, you know, DiBiase.
I don't know. And what's more important is the Smoking Guns don't know, and that's a big mistake. They're going to defend their titles against one man they know and an unknown. That's not smart.
Ooh, Chris Tipton just caught one right on the ramus of the mandible there. No, he's in trouble early on in this one.
On the what?
Ramus of the mandible, where it articulates with the mandibular fossa of the temple. Why do I bother even explaining it to you?
I'm not sure you understand what you're talking about.
Well, the crybaby, Owen Hart, the king, claiming to be the king anyway, with a chance to become World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion.
Speaking of crybabies, we're going to see a crybaby here in a little while as we're going to take a look at what happened last Monday night on Raw when my man Kama came out and made a monkey out of All-Pro Steve McMichael.
Irish Whip coming up here. Yeah, he came out and made a fool of himself.
I didn't see it that way.
Well, he got slammed in the concrete, didn't he?
They were rolling around. My man was on top, pal.
He was?
Yes, he was.
Well, I didn't see it that way.
Well, he didn't have those glasses on.
Folks, just a reminder, mark this down on your calendar. What a blockbuster this is going to be this Tuesday from 12 noon to 1 p.m., the first ever World Wrestling Federation Times Square pre-WrestleMania workout. In the middle of Times Square for 1 hour, New York will stand still.
Ooh, what a
every superstar in the World Wrestling Federation who's going to be at WrestleMania will be at this workout, DiBiase, and you're in big trouble.
Big trouble. Hey, I'm going to be there too, Monsoon.
That suplex, yes, well executed.
There's going to be so many people at Times Square. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get a limousine in, and I may have to be dropped in by helicopter.
There's the chant. We want Brett, the excellence of execution.
Ooh,
nice. Very backbreaker there. Well executed indeed by Owen Hart, the king.
I'll tell you who I'd like to see show up at this workout. LT.
What makes you think he wouldn't?
Because he's scared, that's why.
Wouldn't you stop?
I'd love for him to show up.
Chris here showing us a little offense right now. Nice reversal, though, by Owen. And, well, nice elevation on that backdrop.
After a little workout with Bam Bam, you think he's scared now? He might not even show up to WrestleMania. Maybe
Rocket
he better not.
King all the way up. Top turnbuckle. Tipped it a long ways away here. Oh, he went in the wrong direction and walked into a whole heap of trouble.
Boy, I can see those endorsements now, Monsoon.
What a dog.
Everybody's going to be calling Bam Bam and the Million Dollar Man. They're going to want us on The Tonight Show. They're going to want us on Larry King. They're going to want us on all those shows.
Yeah, you'll be on Most Wanted. Oh, there it is. The Sharpshooter.
The King of Hearts, definitely in shape. He's ready for WrestleMania 11. Smoking Guns, look out. You're going to drop those belts.
Boy, this one is history and in a hurry. Of course, Smoking Guns will be at a disadvantage, not knowing who the partner of the Rocket King, Owen Hart, is going to be at WrestleMania 11. Look at this.
Oh, please, I love it.
Give me a break. Don't forget, folks, still to come here this week.
I'll tell you what's coming up. My man, the Supreme Moneymaker Machine, Kama, will be here.
Gee, can't keep you quiet for a moment. Daryl Peterson, better known as Mad Bob Rock, will join us as well.
Then we'll have Jacob and Eli Blue.
And the bad guy, Razor Ramon, looking for the gold, will also be here when we come back.
Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Stephanie Wyand. It's hot. It's sizzling. It's happening tonight. I'm talking about Sunday Night Slam, the prelude to WrestleMania 11. Events that happen this evening could change the face of what we see at WrestleMania 11. In the most dangerous of matches, a cage match made in the USA, Lex Luger and Tatanka will meet. WWF President Jack Tunney has said it must happen, and I can tell you, Luger is ready to go.
No more help from your friends. Just you and me one-on-one. We're going to settle this once and for all.
Well, Tatanka ran last time, but it doesn't sound like he'll run again.
A 15-foot-high steel cage! And guess what it reminds me of? It reminds me of how your ancestors put my ancestors on one little square circle of land. And Luger, I'm gonna beat you down! beat you down, and I'm going to finish you. And when it's all over and done, I am going to be claimed victorious.
And remember this, Luger. There'll be no WrestleMania for you.
You'll also see Mr. Bob Backlund battle for the Intercontinental Championship, an opportunity he gained in an unconventional way. And I can tell you, Double J is not pleased about it.
Bob Backlund, you are going to find out that not only am I the world's greatest singer and the world's greatest entertainer, but I'm going to take that chicken wing and put it on you. I'm going to put my figure four on you. And one thing is for darn sure, Double J's walking out a winner. And that's not a threat. That's a promise.
Well, it's sure to be quite a battle because Bob Backlund's not giving any ground.
You're not up to my level yet. And when we get into that ring, very soon,
I'm gonna lambaste you, you're gonna renunciate, and you know who your superior is and will be.
And in a battle of the big men, Bam Bam Bigelow takes on the man he pinned during the tag team tournament, Sione of the Head Shrinkers.
You know, Sione's going to be one great competition, but I have to say that Sunday night, it's going to be Bam Bam Sunday Slam.
No matter how you slice it, New York, it's hot, it's happening tonight. This and much more, let me tell you, Big Daddy Cool Diesel in an exclusive interview with Vince McMahon. Who knows what will happen? The whole face of WrestleMania 11 could change this evening.
Welcome back, everyone. Sit back and relax. You are going to be entertained right now.
Will you sit back and relax? And don't embarrass me by getting up and dancing in the street.
Quiet. Unlike Double J, this guy's got talent.
Consideration paid for by the following.
The World Wrestling Federation presents WrestleMania 11 exclusively on pay-per-view. The countdown continues. WrestleMania is just 7 days away.
In Mega Man X2, you must eliminate the X-Hunters or face total extinction. From Capcom on Super NES, in store soon.
Kraft Handy Snacks. Kids love them because they're fun. Moms love them because they're made with real cheese from Kraft. Handy Snacks. You can't imagine a better snack.
Welcome back, everyone. Man, Mom about to get into action here. Just a reminder, this Tuesday, 12 noon to 1 p.m., first time ever, the World Wrestling Federation Times Square pre-WrestleMania workout. Everybody and their grandmother will be there.
It's going to be like a who's who Gorilla Monsoon. Every superstar of the World Wrestling Federation competing at WrestleMania 11, including yours truly. I'll be there. As a matter of fact, we're landing the corporate helicopter on top of the World Trade Center.
You are?
That's right.
Won't be able to see Times Square from there.
Oh, come on, Monsoon. Going to be a lot of people in town. Everybody.
I guarantee you this, DiBiase. LT will be there, too.
He's not going to show up.
Are you kidding?
He doesn't have the guts.
Oh, look at that nice takedown.
If he does show up, he'll probably have all those all pros with him.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Yeah, well,
you'll have all the corporate members there, won't you?
Well, yeah. We're all superstars of the World Wrestling Federation.
There will also be thousands and thousands of people. Don't worry about if you can't see the ring because you can watch it on the big Jumbotron.
Have you heard what LT's been saying at the press conference?
Yeah, I heard.
Yeah.
He's telling the truth.
He's not coming to wrestle. He's coming to brawl. Give me a break.
Hey, he's going to be right at home in Times Square. Big Apple's his backyard, you know.
No, it's not.
It's not.
No, the Meadowlands is across the river.
Oh, please. Chump Evans out on the concrete here. Man Mountain Rock with that new hairdo. This guy's a powerhouse.
You know, he doesn't realize it, but not only is Bam Bam Bigelow a very seasoned veteran and a great wrestler.
Oh, there it is!
Who?
He got him with a whammy bar!
He didn't get the name Beast from the East by just being a wrestler.
He did.
He's a brawler from way back.
I understand that, and I'm sure LT does too.
Yeah.
Chalk up another one in the win column for Man Mountain Rock. What a future this guy's got ahead of him.
Well, I'll tell you what, Big Gorilla Monsoon, the future in the World Wrestling Federation of Lawrence Taylor will come to an abrupt halt.
Hey,
at WrestleMania 11.
Where'd you leave your playbook?
What? Don't worry about my playbook.
Well, a lot of guys worried about your playbook. Well, folks, that was at the World Wrestling Federation Royal Rumble. Bam Bam Bigelow and NFL legend Lawrence Taylor became the center of the sports world attention after the shove felt round the world. And before the shock of the incident had worn off, Bigelow went on to taunt Lawrence Taylor and eventually challenged LT to drop the football pads and step into the ring. And then at a worldwide press conference, LT accepted the challenge and, hey, had to face one of his toughest opponents, the media.
Whether or not your career, which was so outstanding in football, whether this wrestling event tarnishes that career at all?
You know, I just exercise my right to do what I want to do pretty much. No, my football career, it was a good career. It was a good run. It lasted 13 years, but that's over with. Life goes on. I can't just sit back and live off of what I did in the past. I got to live on for the future, so it's whatever I want to do now.
Has retirement got so boring for you that you stoop to this?
Actually, I wouldn't call it stupid. I think that comment is unnecessary. Now, retirement is fun. I enjoy retirement, but I'm working here for a whole new group of athletes. And believe me, whether you believe it or not, these guys are real athletes.
Voice their concerns that this might tarnish your image as a football player.
Well, what I see it like this, if I put in 13 years of football, and I've done a lot of things that hasn't been done in the world of football. If what I do on April the 2nd is going to tarnish what I did for 13 years, and the 13 years I put in one worth it anyway, so what the hell?
Well, folks, we referred to it a little bit earlier on in the program, what happened last Monday night on Raw. Steve McMichael joining Vince McMahon for commentary, and Kama came and stuck his nose in.
Come April 2nd, WrestleMania, I get my hands on you, I am going to beat you like the dog that you are.
Just ignore it.
Well,
tell me something else.
If you have a problem with that, what I suggest you do
all right, we've
is
had enough
stand
of this.
Up like a man and do something about it.
Now, wait a minute.
These are ass suspenders here, my man.
Hey! Whoa!
Yeah, go away. Wait.
What is going on? McMahon got a comic on that. Wait a minute. Stop it. Wait a minute.
Of what we could possibly see at WrestleMania 11. Imagine what it'll be like when all six of LT's all pros get into it with the corporation.
I can't wait.
The latest acquisition, of course, Kama. DiBiase referring to him as the money-making machine. Well, he'll definitely have his hands full at WrestleMania 11. And so will some other corporate members. Let's not forget, King Kong Bundy will step in at WrestleMania 11 and face the Urnless One, the Grim Reaper himself, The Undertaker. Of course, we all know that the urn is in the possession of the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, who doesn't have a clue what to do with it or how to use it, but he's got it. Bob Cook supplying the opposition here for Kama. Nice duck under there into a hammerlock. Kama reversing quick. Oh, nice fireman's carry. This guy has some tremendous tools that he brings to the ring. Well, he will need them all at WrestleMania 11 because according to the million-dollar man Ted DiBiase's playbook, it will be Kama who will have his sights set on McMichaels. And let's face it, McMichaels, one of the biggest men in the NFL, but Hey, he's not as big as Kama. In fact, all of the All-Pro team will be looking up to the corporate members at WrestleMania 11. Cook with a right hand, catching Kama right in the kisser. Well, let's look at this scenario. If Kama and Bundy take on Reggie White and Steve McMichaels, at least that's what it says in the playbook, the Packers would be in a whole heap of trouble on the defensive side of the ball this season. Oh, look at that. Come on, ref. Step in there. Third man in the ring, Mike Chioda, one of the premier referees here in the World Wrestling Federation. Oh, wow, what a right hand. Vicious right hook right in the ribcage area. Kama is indeed a handful. The entire world waiting with great anticipation for WrestleMania 11. Can the all-pro NFL legend LT step into the ring and compete with a seasoned veteran, the likes of the Beast of the East, Bam Bam Bigelow? Well, only time will tell that. Maybe we won't have to wait that long. Maybe it'll happen this Tuesday as the World Wrestling Federation goes to Times Square for its pre-WrestleMania workout. I know Bam Bam's going to be there, and hey, LT will be there as well, take my word for it.
Let's make this punk pay.
Oh, come on, DiBiase. Give me a break. Youngster trying to make a name for himself here in the World Wrestling Federation. Instead, he could have his career terminated right here this week. Well, look at this. I don't believe that. Kama not exactly following the advice of the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, or the orders, you might say. Maybe there'd be a little something lacking in his paycheck this week. Look at DiBiase. Well, he's happy.
Everybody's going to pay.
Why not? He's got a golden opportunity coming up at WrestleMania 11 to really put the corporation on the map by once and for all ending the career of a legend, Lawrence Taylor. Well, folks, FanFest at WrestleMania 11 will be a blockbuster, the second annual one. Of course, it all started at WrestleMania 10 in Madison Square Garden. A chance for you to get up close and personal with the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation.
Hi, this is Todd Pettengill bringing you another World Wrestling Federation Fan Festival Minute. The Fan Festival is sponsored by Tyco RC Maximum Heat, makers of the hottest radio-controlled vehicles available today. The World Wrestling Federation Fan Festival will be held at the Hartford Civic Center Exhibition Hall from Friday, March 31st through Sunday, April 2nd. The Fan Festival is the experience of a lifetime. It's interactive, so you can experience the WWF in a hands-on style like never before. And you'll have seven big opportunities to enjoy the Fan Festival. On Friday, March 31st, doors open at 3:30 p.m. and again at 7:30 p.m. On Saturday the 1st, doors open at 10 a.m., again at 2, and once more at 7. And on Sunday, April 2nd, doors open at 10:30, and for the last time at 2 p.m. Come one, come all, and don't forget to bring a camera. Tickets are on sale now at the Hartford Civic Center box office or all Ticketmaster locations in the Northeast. Call 203-525-4500. The Fan Festival from the WWF.
If I have to fold one more box, I'm going to snap.
Did you say snap?
Snap into a Slim Jim! Get a little excitement, snap into a Slim Jim!
Welcome back, folks. It's Todd Pettengill here with your WrestleMania report, and we are counting down to the greatest WrestleMania of all time. WrestleMania 11, next Sunday night, April the 2nd, from the sold-out Hartford Civic Center, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, and only on pay-per-view cable television. Now, if I were you, I'd get on the horn and contact my local cable company and place my order. Tell the operator you want your WrestleMania from the World Wrestling Federation, and you will not be disappointed in the least. I mean, we've been talking about classic confrontations. How about Bam Bam Bigelow and Lawrence Taylor? Man, you just saw Kama, who is now part of the Million Dollar Corporation. Clearly, he and Steve McMichael are not done yet. Who knows what's going to happen between DiBiase's WWF and the stars of the NFL. It's going to be great, and I wouldn't miss it for anything in the world. Now, at this year's WrestleMania, WWF Championship also on the line between the champion, Big Daddy Cool Diesel, and his former tag team partner and former friend, Shawn Michaels. who has an equalizer of sorts in his new bodyguard, Sid. Now, Diesel has an unbelievable schedule next weekend. He'll be a guest on the Jon Stewart Show. He's got Rock and Jock Softball. He'll be on MTV with sports guy Dan Cortez. These are all the responsibilities of being the WWF champion, and Diesel has handled the role masterfully. Now, meantime, Shawn Michaels has been running around Hollywood with Baywatch star Pamela Anderson, but he's like a changed man. Shawn is primed and 100% focused on defeating Diesel. Let's take you back to the WrestleMania press conference. Check out what Shawn Michaels said about his former friend.
We are about to embark on a new generation. Granted, this man to my left feels that he is the leader of the new generation. That is where we have somewhat of a conflict. See, Big Daddy Cool had the pleasure of walking into the World Wrestling Federation and latching on to the hottest commodity this sport has ever known, that being me. While on the other hand, yours truly worked his tail off, and after, like I said, 7 long years, and after going through 29 of the world's greatest World Wrestling Federation superstars, I am now in the main event in the biggest pay-per-view extravaganza that there can be, WrestleMania 11.
No question, folks, this should be the best WWF title match in recent history. Now, at WrestleMania, you will also see the man from the dark side, the unearthly Undertaker, do battle with the volatile King Kong Bundy. Who knows what's going to happen when these two individuals lock up? Bundy guarantees he won't join the long list of superstars who've been banished from this place, but the Undertaker wants to throw a little dirt on that idea.
Oh, the million-dollar corporation. You think you're so smart, but the power of the urn is useless to you, and just for my Undertaker.
Throughout the annals of time, Bundy, me and my kind were the target of people like you, people who try to destroy us. That urn means nothing to you, and even though you have possession, don't think that I can't draw the power. And with my creatures of the night, Bundy, at WrestleMania, I will make an example of you, and you will rest in peace.
Can this night get any bigger? Yes, it can. The legendary Bret the Hitman Hart will lock up with Mr. Bob Backlund in an I Quit match. And put very simply, that's how you win, by getting your opponent to say those two little words, I quit. Bret Hart does not know the meaning of those two little words, and Bob Backlund doesn't know any little words.
Everybody knows that I've got the biggest rule breaker in the WWF in WrestleMania 11 in the Hitman. I've never broke a rule in my life, but in this match, I quit match, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to procure the chicken wing on him once and for all, and he's going to say, I quit, Mr. Backlund.
The WWF Intercontinental title is also on the line as Double J Jeff Jarrett with the ever-present roadie takes on the former Intercontinental Champion, the bad guy Razor Ramon, who has now announced that the 1-2-3 Kid will be in his corner. We'll get to see the bad guy in action here this week, so stay with us. Now, also at WrestleMania this year, the WWF tag title on the line when the Smoking Guns give Owen Hart and a mystery partner a shot at the gold. And you got to believe the Guns are a little bit gun-shy after what Mom pulled again earlier on. We'll also have another tag match for you as Made in the USA Lex Luger and the British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith team up to take on Jacob and Eli Blue. We will see the Brothers Blue in action coming up next. Next Sunday night, WrestleMania 11, totally live on pay-per-view. Please, folks, do not be left out. Oh, speaking of not being left out, check this out. Don't be left out. Go pick up today's New York Daily News right in the comic section, free color poster. Doesn't get any better than that. Lawrence Taylor, WrestleMania 11. Go out and get today's New York Daily News after you turn me on. Okay?
America. And we'll see you live next Sunday night.
Come April 2nd, we'll be adding a little salt and pepper to WrestleMania 11.
Here I go again.
That's right, we're going to serenade Lawrence Taylor into the ring alive, as only salt and pepper can.
You made me want to shoot.
Uh-huh, you don't want to miss this performance. LT and the whole world is going to get fantasized. Get away.
Challenge is brought to you by Skittles bite-sized candy. Pair thousands of fruit flavor combinations in every bag of Skittles. Here we go with Eli and Jacob Blue. And of course with them you get yours truly.
That's right, Gorilla Monsoon, Uncle Zebekiah. He may not look very smart, Gorilla Monsoon, but hey, you gotta give him credit. He hasn't been here very long, and he's got his boys in WrestleMania 11.
Well, they've got some tough competition, too, in the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith and Lex Luger. What a match that's going to be.
Oh, I can't wait. As a matter of fact, I think that's going to be a big surprise to Luger and the Bulldog.
You do?
Yes, I do. It may surprise everybody. I think that these guys are potential World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
These guys are certainly a handful, the generically mirrored twins. I was talking with, well, I'm not sure who I was talking about, whether it was Eli or Jacob, but he wasn't even sure who he was.
Oh, come on.
Well, that's what he said.
Yeah, he wasn't going to tell you.
Look at them. Go to work immediately. They are relentless. They just like to get in there and hammer away and brawl. I guess that's what they do best.
Yeah, they like to beat people up. I like that attitude. Well,
Chad Bird and Ray Hudson supplying the opposition. Not much of it.
Chad Bird, is that Larry's boy?
Will you stop? Now, which one is that? Which one is that, Ted? Do you know?
I haven't got a clue.
I figured that. Anybody can't figure out how to open the urn, give me a break. Ooh, wow, hard into the corner. Of course, Lex this Sunday on the Slam faces Tatanka in the 15-foot high steel cage. Is the Native American running scared ready for that?
Is he ready for that, Monsoon? Hey, we have got Luger right where we want him.
You do?
Wrapped like a rat in that steel cage.
He could be humiliated nationally, you know.
Oh, that ain't going to happen.
Well,
we got him where we want him. I mean, how many times has he tried to beat the Tonka and he hadn't been able to get the job done? Now he thinks he's going to get in a cage and do it? He can't run.
Ooh, wow.
He can't
Did
hide anywhere.
That? Well, that's why the 15-foot high steel cage is there. To settle everything once and for all. Oh, look at that. He didn't even want to come in. He wasn't even tagged in.
I tell you what, these two gentlemen, Eli and Jacob Blue, are surprising a lot of people. They're going to surprise Lex Luger and Davey Boy Smith at WrestleMania 11. There are going to be a lot of surprises at WrestleMania 11.
Boy, I'm sure there are.
We're going to have a brand new World Wrestling Federation champion.
Now, wait a minute.
Shawn Michaels will take out Diesel.
Are you predicting that? Obviously, you are.
Of course I am.
Well, you've been wrong before.
Well, Shawn's got a lot of backup. Big backup. You know, Psycho Sid, remember him? That's pretty big backup. And hey, remember what happened a little bit earlier today? Been on a mission. Was I right? Did I not call it right?
You were as shocked as everybody else, DiBiase.
I wasn't shocked. I knew all along what was going to happen.
Give me a break.
Who do you think told him how to trap him?
What?
I set that up.
Oh, please. Boy, you jump in and take credit for anything, won't you?
Only where it's due.
Oh, look out! Perched up there in midair. Whoa, boy.
Ooh.
Forget about it, folks. This one is history.
You don't think Shawn Michaels can beat Diesel, huh?
I think it's going to be a tremendous matchup. And, hey, there's always the possibility when you step into the ring with the World Wrestling Federation champion that you could come out as the newly crowned one. But I'll tell you what. If Psycho Sid stays in the corner where he belongs, I think Diesel will handle his former partner, Shawn Michaels.
There's not a more cunning fox in the World Wrestling Federation than Shawn Michaels. I'm predicting the new champion.
When we come back, the bad guy, Razor Ramon, will be in action right after this.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Travel through the Stargate to a new dimension of gameplay featuring hostile enemies, high-tech gliders, and incredible morphing effects on Super NES, Genesis, Game Boy, and Game Gear from Acclaim. True Lies explodes onto your favorite video game system. It's up to you to battle fanatical terrorists and save the world from nuclear destruction from Acclaim.
The World Wrestling Federation presents WrestleMania 11, exclusively on pay-per-view. The countdown continues. WrestleMania is just 7 days away.
Welcome back, everyone. Wait till you hear the tremendous ovation that's about to explode here for the bad guy himself, Razor Ramon.
Yes, there he is, Gorilla Monsoon, the man who is a legend in his own mind.
Will you stop?
Well, he thinks he's seven. He thinks he's hot.
Well, he is hot.
Yeah.
And at WrestleMania 11, well, he'll get a chance, perhaps, to once again become the reigning Intercontinental Champion, but that's sort of all up in the air right now, DiBiase.
It certainly is, because Double J has to face none other than Mr. Bob Backlund on the Sunday Night Slam, and should Bob Backlund win the title, then Razor Ramon has to face Double J anyway at WrestleMania 11, and no title on the line.
So what you're saying is that, in fact, the bad guy Razor Ramon could be cheering for Double J on the Sunday Night Slam.
How about that? Well, I like it.
Can't really see that happening, but I know the bad guy wants in the worst way to get his gold back, and oh, look at this.
This makes me sick.
And of course, if it all happens and Double J gets by Paranoid Bob Backlund, well, Razor's got a plan. He might say a little game plan of his own. In the corner of Razor Ramon at WrestleMania 11 will be none other than the dynamic, exciting, unbelievable 1-2-3 Kid.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding.
Where did you hear that?
Well, Gorilla Vine knows all.
I can't believe it.
You haven't heard that?
No, I haven't.
Where you been, under a big rock somewhere?
Stop it. Hey, look, Double J's got the roadie in his corner.
So, what does that mean?
The roadie's pretty shady, you know.
Well, he is. He's the one that caused Double J to become the champ in the first place.
And now look, Shawn Michaels has got Psycho Sid in his corner. Now there's somebody to have in your corner. Razor Ramon is the 1-2-3 punk. I mean, so what?
Wasn't it the 1-2-3 Kid who humiliated you guys at the Royal Rumble and took the titles away from you?
Humiliated us. We tripped over ourselves.
You certainly did. The Black Phantom here supplying the opposition for the bad guy, Razor Ramon, who looks to be over that leg injury about 100%. Nice arm wringer. Reverse now to a standing wrist lock. Oh, boy, that one hurts. Turn it right into a nice hammerlock now.
You know, Gorilla Monsoon, as much as I know this is going to pain you, I got to let you know that I'm not going to be here with you next week.
You what?
No, I'm not going to be here.
Why not?
WrestleMania 11 is coming up. I've got to get the corporation ready. I got to go work on the playbook.
Are you? Oh, please. Give, you going to leave me alone again?
Well, I know it's hard for you to do this without me.
Oh,
but
wow, look at that shot.
I found a replacement.
Big deal out of the car. Who is it? Not Nikolai.
You'll be surprised.
Send Nikolai here. But I got some place you can send him, though, DiBiase. 1 week from this Monday, the World Wrestling Federation Monday Night Raw will rock the Mid-Hudson Civic Center on Monday, April 3rd, 7 p.m. And get this, tickets for this spectacular extravaganza are even on sale now.
The entire corporation will be there, Monsoon.
It will.
And it's one night after WrestleMania 11. We'll still be celebrating the victory over LT.
You think you're still going to be able to show your face anywhere, right?
You know I will.
Give me a break. Don't forget, folks, mark it down on your calendar. 1 week from this Monday, Monday Night Raw at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center. That's April 3rd, 7 p.m. is when it all kicks off. Bad guy having a good time here at the expense of the Black Phantom.
Real
watch
comedian,
this. Oh, here it comes. Abdominal stretch. Suck it in deep, too. We could have a submission right here. Oh, look at that little extra leverage by lifting up the leg. How about Jonathan Taylor Thomas? Guest broadcaster. What is that all about?
How about Jenny McCarthy, MTV, guest timekeeper? I thought you'd mention her. You're always, you know, you always have an eye on the girls here, Monsoon.
You know what I don't understand, DiBiase? Why you're not going to be here next week? You're saying because of the importance of WrestleMania 11. Well, there's no way at WrestleMania 11 the corporation's going to come out of there with any gold. You're not involved in any title matches.
Hey, what we're going to win at WrestleMania 11 is more valuable than gold.
Oh, look out here.
I mean, when Bam Bam Bigelow defeats Lawrence Taylor, the honor, the prestige that will come.
Oh, look out, yes.
That looks like LT going down in flames.
Please.
The honor, the prestige, the notoriety that we will gain from that victory is worth all the gold in the world.
It is.
I mean, look at all the endorsements we'll get. Everybody will want us.
That guy saying that's it. We are about to see the patented razor's edge of the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
Well, enjoy it while you can there, Greaseball, because you won't be seeing it at WrestleMania 11.
Here it comes, hoisted up on his shoulders.
Boy, it looks like he had a little trouble getting him up there.
Well, hey, That Black Phantom, you know, is hovering around that 300-pound mark. Ooh, wow, there it is. He won't have that much trouble at WrestleMania 11 getting Double J up there.
Yeah, well, don't count on that.
Oh, boy. Is he ready? Is that confidence? Is he oozing machismo?
That's grease, not machismo. I hate this guy.
Chalked up another one in to win. California bad guy Razor Ramon on his way to WrestleMania 11.
He's just too cocky. I mean, I'm cocky, but I'm rich. I got a reason to be cocky.
Oh, please. Have you taken stock lately of your corporate members? That'll slow you down a little bit. 20 more steps to come. We'll be right back.